here.
Who cares?
Hey, dudes and dudettes. This is Perry Caravello, professional skateboarder, snowboarder, actor, comedian, rock enthusiast, star of the cult classic film Windy City Heat, and the king of Fright Night comedy. And now, here's your boy, and my favorite black guy, Wes Most.
What is going on, everyone? Happy Thursday, or Friday, I guess, depending on where you are in the world. I'm joined tonight by TLI, who literally just got here, a fucking diva. And
is that a problem?
And Reboard, who was here minutes early so that we can plot out what we're doing today. We can get our skits and our songs together.
A whole 30 minutes.
Versus TLI, who just kind of strolls in when he feels like it.
Finishing my chicken cutlets.
Well, I mean, when you get them at the dollar store, they're going to expire that date. So you had to cook it today.
Yeah, come on. They were already turning gray when I got it at the grocery store.
You put enough gravy on that, though, it's going to be fine.
Can't even see the gray underneath that gravy.
No. So what's going on, Reborn? Welcome to the stream.
Hello. Not much. I mean,
nice.
Go right over here, you know.
So I thank you for the opening song. I asked, thank you
for playing my favorite song.
I asked Reborn. I said, Reborn, who's in your opinion, who's the most influential black artist in your life? And he said, oh, there can only be one. There can only be one. It's Slick. And he sent me the song from Pile Driver 2, the WWF album featuring the hit song If You Only Knew.
He says the figure four in the song. I mean, how
he does? He does say, "Don't you put me on the floor on the figure four? She a job soul, bro. A job soul, bro." That song's amazing. You can't tell me it's not. So hey, we have the call. Everyone else gets to see them, but we're gonna start with girlfriend. I think it's called Girlfriend Ring.
Probably.
TLI. You're the resident expert on these things. Oh, I don't know. I just got here.
See, I just got here.
Now, man, if you would have been here beforehand.
Are you asking me right now?
The TLI, are you really the owner of the largest collection of White Mama memorabilia?
Of course I am. That doesn't mean I know every little Lorne fact, you know?
Now, Reborn actually has no title. So let's say hi to everyone. And then we'll get started. I've got Tommy M, who of course will be here on the replay crew. Trent O'Gwynn, Decon versus the Dark, Punk Pansy, Cyber Street, Ricky Spanish, Guru, who of course is my lead moderator. Who, when I need something done, when I need the dirty work done, Guru is going to be there. The actual sheriff of Cornville, Scott 619, representing San Diego. Brandeezy, Foshizy, Polynomial Purebred, Honest, Hey Y'all, Kaylee Slimebucket, Witch Lady, Dr. Cunt, Will Smith, Page Master, Sonic Fiction, Sloth Cat, Nothing Better Than That, my co-host for Mo Negroes, which will be returning on Monday night. Hopefully Cornville Three-Way will be joining us for that stream because, I mean, obviously, right? Bud Roscoe, Private Dink, Vexus Girl, Kahootin, Evil Little McNuggets, Road Scholar, Pussy Destroyer, Enter the Codverse, Sadface 09, Asbury Brad, who provided the thumbnail for tonight, Moten G, Omani's Dad, Robert Oslin, Becca, Camila, Moten G, Omani's Dad, that my song right there, yeah, this is an amazing song, Mandy S7, I also like Girls in Cars, wasn't that from the Can-Am Connection? Evil Nuggets, no, Egbert Mandingo, Gila 2, I don't know what that's, Gila 2, let me know if I have that close, Cornville Counselor, who of course reminds you guys that this is a bully-free zone, Dan's Jeans, La Senorita, Junior, J.R. Davis, Eliminancy, Janine, DJ Payne 1, who gets us banned. We are officially banned in Russia now. I don't know if you guys know that, but this show is officially banned in Russia. And why are we banned in Russia? Well, it's because the only way I know how to hype up my moderators and get them ready for the dirty work that's required to be one of my lead moderators is this song right here.
You were the wrench moderator. That's what the wrenches mean, right? Moderator, wrench, moderator, wrench, moderator. You showed me right there that you were the wrench moderator. But guess what?
But guess what? What's it gonna be, Playboy?
What's it gonna be, Playboy?
No, 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 you don't say it.
Oh, right, I forgot. Yeah, no, I got the soundbite played in my ear instead.
Shh, shh.
What's it gonna be, Playboy?
Thank you. Yeah, listen, unless I point to you, why don't you just, you know, let me do my thing.
Yeah, good point. I was listening to this, that Smooth Moderator's stream last night. And he was, of course, doing a tribute to Wine Lover, one of the last true Lornographers.
Was he really?
And he was. And he called Lornmas Lornamas. And I really want to call it that from now on.
Lorenzo Lornamas? I like that.
Cornville Lornamas.
Izzy Stardust, Cornville Three-Way, who will be joining us, for Mo Negroes, Dr. Cunt, Dr. Cassandra...
A lot of doctors.
Zach, yeah, well, you know, I am really popular in medical crowd. Zachy, internet fuck friend Stanford, Kim S, who is a bully, and I think that's everyone. Logan W, and yeah, voice to voice, medium syllables, and then, you know, Dr. Payne One as well. And then our replay crew, and I'm gonna list them down here. Crispy Treat, Aaron W, Lord Tebow Baggins, Kit Kat Meow, Tommy M, Time Machine, Punk Pansy, who might be back, Tiffany Lockhart, who stalks me, Jesse Pickles, and Officer Neesnaw, Slash's wife, and of course, your mom. Thank you guys. Now, I know, we're just the house cleaning here. I did get something special from Blue Boy. Again, Blue Boy, always been a friend of the show. Blue Boy, what do you have for me? He actually had Lorne. Well, this is in honor of Black History Month as well, so why don't I just play it?
This ain't what you want. Project, this ain't what you want.
He doesn't look out of place in that, honestly.
I think that black dude got served. If you're asking me, Lorne won that battle. Vex, what do you think?
Dance for us, clown. Dance for us, you monkey bitch.
Jesus Christ.
Vex! That's not how you talk to people.
You can't say that to people.
That's what is wrong with you.
Dance for us, clown. Dance for us, you monkey bitch.
That's going to get a lot of play. I can already.
I think she's talking to you, Reborn. So
yeah.
So
why don't you
dance for us and then we'll get started. All right. Well, let you guys ready to start.
Yeah. I just want to say that I was told this was a two-man operation.
But guess what? all right. Well, let's listen to Lorne Thring, sing Three's Company.
This is his favorite show.
Of course it is.
Come and knock on our door. We've been waiting for you. We're the kitchen star, hers and his. Please come on in. Come and dance on our floor. Except it is new. With a lovable space that needs your face. Please come on in.
I don't remember these credits. It's been a while since I've seen Three's Company, but I don't remember Kayla, X Derek, or a 400-page chat log being listed in the credits of Three's Company. But I do remember Chris Hansen and his no hanky panky rule. So that was there.
You see that life is a ball again. Laughter is calling for you.
Down in our rendezvous. Not Dubba Dubba Dubba. What was that?
Dubba Dubba Dubba.
It's his favorite song. It's his favorite. I don't know all the fucking lyrics.
It's 80s fucking songs.
How am I supposed to know all the words?
Yeah,
nice.
Three's company two.
Beautiful.
God, he's
melancholy
sucks.
Mood. Who, melancholy mood? Oh, lovely. Nice.
No,
well, Lauren, guys, you guys heard it here first. Reborn thinks melancholy mood sucks.
Damn.
Yeah, that was harsh.
It was.
Good morning, baby. I'm not going to say anything yet. I'm going to wait till after I'm done singing you the song.
Oh, you're going to lose viewers when you start singing, man.
And it's
no. No.
And I know you don't like country.
The singing and the phone sex. Lose them every time.
You do.
Ooh.
They read you Cinderella. Hoped it would come true that one day your Prince Charming would come rescue you. Like romantic movies, you never will forget.
I've never seen him look older than he does right here.
Yeah.
I mean, he's really not that old, but and it looks like there's a line around his head, like it was removed and then sewed back on poorly. Look at
that's just like there's a. Go ahead.
What?
It's because he always wears a hat, right?
There's a like it looks like there's an actual crease on his head where it was put back on poorly.
Years of hat wearing will do that.
It's off by a
centimeter. He's looking like fucking like Ebenezer Splooge over here.
That okay. Are you saying that's a nightshirt? Is that a full nightshirt that he's wearing?
It's a full nightshirt, a full nightgown. I think he's going to be visited by three ghosts.
Dude, Jorn actually had, when Jorn got busted, his very last thing he said to Euro was he had a dream. He had a dream that he was visited by Lorne, who was trying to, like, that was going to be a sketch. He was visited by three Lornes who were going to try and convince him that he was just as bad as them.
Wow. But of course, it's not true because he's.
Well, yeah, that's the joke. Yeah. That's
The joke was that he's not as bad as Lorne.
Well, I mean, his eyes are bluer than his stupid, right? How can he be as bad as Lorne with really blue eyes?
That's a superpower, from what I've heard.
Juliet, all this time that you've been waiting. You don't have to wait no more. I can love you like that. I would make you my world. Move heaven and earth. If you were my girl, I would give you my heart. Be all that you need.
He's really
show
trying.
You your
yes, this is forever. Strong.
Dude, I'm gonna say
he's taking time off his life.
I don't think this is the worst. Well, I don't think this is the worst that he sounded though. I'm gonna be honest. I he sounds better than Jorn. I don't think this is the worst that he sounded. I think the songs within his range. I know this song from All for One, the 90s R&B Boyz II Men ripoff, multicultural ripoff. That's where I know this. I don't think this is the worst he sounded. What do you think, Reborn?
I think the only time he ever sounded good is when he sang Leanne Rimes, but.
that is my favorite. He does hit those high notes. What do you think? What do you think, TLI?
I mean, this is not the worst he sounded. If I thought he had the brain power to retain the lyrics, I'd love to hear him sing like "Señorita" by Justin Timberlake.
Who cares?
I was waiting for something.
Rude. Wow.
Yeah. Wow. I was waiting for something to assault me.
I think a moderator did that.
Yeah, was that a moderator?
That was Guru.
God damn it, Guru! Now I'm mad at you.
If you give me
congrats,
a
invoked my ire.
You did that, Guru. You did that.
I can love you like that.
You tell me that's like one of his good ranges right there. That
I'm saying it's not the worst. All right, Reborn. How about you hit a little? How about you hit a little? I can love you like that for us while we're waiting.
I can't. Do that.
Just a couple lines.
Lauren just can't hit notes like you know like that. He can't do that.
he shouldn't be doing runs. For other than the chorus, though, I think this wasn't the worst that he sounded.
No, he's got a few like this, but you know, it's, I don't know. He's not yelling like he normally does.
Yes, yeah. But I mean, as soon as he stops smoking, though, guys, then we'll see. He's going to prove it to Tiffany Lockhart and all of them.
Well, the second that woman walks through the door, he's going to stop smoking.
That's all it's going to take. That's all it's going to take. You need to give him, you show him a little something, he's going to give you a little something in return, which is a longer life with him. Isn't that nice?
What more could you ask for?
Exactly.
Baseball bat to the head. So.
Barbed wire wrapped around it, maybe.
Yeah, lit on fire.
Little Terry Funk. No, guys, stop.
What I mean, I'm no Casanova, but I swear
that's for sure.
This much is true. I'll be holding nothing back when it comes to you. You dream of love that's everlasting.
Do it, Lauren.
He looks like he has no teeth right now.
Open up your eyes.
He does look like a turtle man, but come on, Reborn. Like, that's not what the point. The point isn't that he looks like a turtle man singing with no teeth. The point is that he's singing from his soul. Maybe that's why he can't appreciate. He's singing from his heart because he's in love. Maybe you don't know what that's like. And that's sad for you. That's sad for you. Maybe now you're the locale.
Gotta rethink my whole life.
I can love you like that. I would make you my world, move heaven and earth. If you were my girl, I will give you my heart, be all that you need, show you your everything that's precious to me. If you give me a chance, I can love you like that. You want tenderness, I got tenderness, and a see-through to the heart of you. If you want a man who understands.
Wait, is he really just singing a full song to Casey?
Mm-hmm. Serenade.
For what?
Just to get the juice.
Is it just a song? Is there also a speech?
No. He's got a little speech after the song, but the song is to like
all right, let's
win
get
the heart over, you know?
This is the appetizer. This is the appetizer to the love buffet, is what you're saying.
Yeah, something like that.
This is just fried wontons before I get up and get myself the main course. Is what you're saying.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Can you actually say those words? In your southern voice.
My southern voice.
Just say this is the appetizer before the buffet, please. One just time in a southern
just
voice.
Just say it's the appetizer before the love buffet, please.
And someone thinks that this is a two-man operation. Just saying.
Before he gets his girlfriend, General Snow's girlfriend. Just
okay, baby. There's a song. And now I want to say something to you.
Oh, he's good. He's getting serious.
I'm sorry for screwing up.
I'm sorry, I'm bad.
For breaking my promise to you.
Can I ask you something? And
yeah.
What is he looking at?
His soul. What are you looking at? Is he looking down?
No, anywhere. He rarely looks at the camera.
I don't know. Well, now I'll have to pay attention because see, I've never seen this. So now I get the. I'll watch. I'll see.
Yeah, watch his eyes. Go back and watch his eyes.
He looks great. I'll tell you that much.
Oh, man. Ain't no way in the world. Sunday's he's not best looking. For her.
I'm sorry for screwing up. For breaking my promise to
you. Wow. Yeah, there's a lot of looking around.
And I can promise that it's not going to happen again. You can keep an eye on me all you want to. And I was very confused. But I don't regret last night happening. Because of the fact that it helped me let go of her.
and I don't regret anything about that. And I really want to fall in love with you. Mm. It's you that I want, and I've known that I've wanted you.
Since last night.
So, I know you say you don't understand it, but I do. So, I'm asking you right now if you will be my girlfriend. And this right here...
He's not taking enough dramatic pauses. See, if this was a Lifetime movie, there would be music swelling right now. Mm-hmm. He's not taking any pauses, any emotional gasp or anything. He's just rushing through. And I'm sure he's practiced this.
He rehearsed this all night.
He did rehearse it. I can't promise you it's not going to happen again. I'm a flawed man, but you know what's not flawed? Our love. See, there's no variations or anything.
The music is probably swelling in his head.
It is swelling in his head.
There's more than music swelling in his head, yeah.
I can see the line here. That's right. Swelling at the top of his cranium.
There's a lot of sway. Yeah, that's the music. Yeah. That's all the music he's got in him.
2-carat diamond. Sterling silver ring. It's a dent, but I'm going to consider it.
I mean, you might be able to trade that for dinner at Burger King. The 2-carat... There's 1,000 diamonds on here, so that's 2-carat total diamond weight, which is basically diamond dust, just sprinkled all over the top of some sterling silver,
some sweet sterling.
Mm. A girlfriend ring. So I'm asking you if you will be my girlfriend.
Sincerely, the pedophile.
Mwah.
Oh my God.
Oh,
why would Blue Boy do that to us? We should just start with 25 minutes. What?
What?
July?
Oh, hello.
Hello?
Oh, there we go.
What did you say? Yeah, well, we still speak English on this stream.
My mic cut off. Okay.
You good?
I am. Yeah, I'm fine now.
Mama, I'm streaming with my friends.
Mama, get out of my room.
Please. Please, Mama, close the basement door. But she did bring you down the hot pocket. At least she says thank you.
Oh, yeah. I did say thank you. That's why I turned the mic off.
That's why you had to pause.
Right. Thank you, Mama.
Oh, someone's butt hurt right now.
Someone's butthole is hurting.
You know what I'm saying? Right. I know exactly who it is.
Good morning, beautiful. Good morning again, precious.
Hey, so I've never got to ask this question. What is this picture? Is this his house, or was this a house he was tearing down? Or is it Barbo?
That's his trailer. He was renovating at the time. I guess it looks great.
How does it look now?
Now I'm not sure, but whenever the robots stopped talking to him, I mean, there was some drywall sheetrock put up over those exposed beams. That's about it.
Oh,
Jesus.
You're looking at the tear down. You don't get to see the rebuild with all the like marble flooring. And
he is the tear down house. He's the fucking Teardown House at the end of the day. Wow, it wasn't like the New England hit with horrifyingly cold temperatures last week. He's still alive, right? Were we confirmed he's still currently alive?
No,
it was like
negative
180 in New Hampshire, literally negative 180 degrees. I don't know that he made it through.
Honestly, if Lorne passes in the middle of the night in his trailer, how long before it's reported? How long until? Someone starts looking for him.
Months?
Yeah, for sure.
How many times does Roy come over and not report it before
right. Yeah. He's not home.
Roy's trying to tell him to get up. He's a
get up, Frank. wasn't Roy drunk in a ditch last week? I don't know. That's Roy, not me. This dude's in his 50s, possibly drunk in a ditch. I don't know. Bitch, I don't know.
Apparently you're not going to respond. I'm supposed to be going to the teardown house today with Roy.
In that weather.
Lorne?
Yeah.
He walks
freezing degree weather. You know,
would he really walk around naked at any time?
He'd walk around naked all the time, yeah. Especially if it was at night.
So is he a nudist, or what is it about nudity and Lorne? Because he wanted to get naked for Kayla immediately too.
He loves being naked. He's an exhibitionist or something. I don't know. He
like to be an exhibitionist, you'd have to want to be seen, right?
True. Yeah. Well, I mean, he loves sending dick pics.
Well, who doesn't? Who does? Like, right? Yeah, preaching to the choir.
but yeah, he'd get home from work, and then like when he knew he was done for the day, he would just get naked and just sit in chairs and imagine what they smell like.
Oh, I can. That's gross. I mean, so he just enjoys the feel. So that would make him a nudist. He just enjoys the feeling of being nude.
Yeah, I guess.
But then also an exhibitionist because he can't wait to get naked for people and then tell them how much they like seeing him naked.
Yeah. Yeah, he'll send like dick pics. There's a call out somewhere where he's like, you didn't even pay attention to the photo I got you. Oh, it actually isn't now. Sorry, but the robot's talking about Will's dick and how she saw it by accident. It's burned into her retinas. And Lauren's like, you didn't even pay attention to the photo I sent you this morning. You didn't care about my dick. You care about Will's dick burning your retinas.
I've got a dick burned in my retinas, doctor. Yeah. It's like when you get image burned on your old big screen TV from keeping Sonic paws too long.
Yeah.
I've got a 10-inch dick burned in my retinas, doctor.
Boy, but Roy stayed at last night, I guess, so I'm not sure if those plans are going to stay the same or not. Going to the teardown house is scrapped. Roy screwed me over to do electrical. I think we should talk today and straighten us back out before we lose each other for good. Call me when you wake up, okay? Provided he's still on us. If you don't call me, then I guess that will tell me that you no longer want us. Thought about talking to Stacey to see if she could give me permission to fly down there for 2 days.
Oh! No. You...
Voicemail. Especially the last song I sang to you. I meant every word of it. Make that the last two songs, I mean.
Four it's fucking three songs. Here
now. You ignored me when I texted you this morning around 2, and I've got nothing from you today. Apparently, your commitment is to your friends than it is to us and our future. I'm in love with you, Jamie, but a one-way relationship doesn't work well. You already know how I feel about being put second to others when it comes to you. I'm trying to save us, but I shouldn't have to try this hard if you and I being together is something you really want as well. I'm going to tell you call me tonight. That way it leaves you the option to either spend time with me or your friends. Something I noticed about the pic you sent me last night. You wrapped a blanket around you so I couldn't see your titch. But you don't mind if Will and MJ know fancy seeing you naked, but not me. The things you do...
Yo, Detective Lorne is back and he's sober now. This is yes. Detective Lorne levels. You remember, Lorne would get drunk and fucking Detective Columbo would come out. And he would start piecing shit together. 6 months ago, I called. And Dan picked up. But I know I wasn't calling Dan. Which leads me to believe... And he starts piecing shit together. And as he gets more lucid, he just gets dumber. This right here, he's looking at the picture and he's like, piece it. Wait a second. Why would she not want me to see her titties? But we'll get to see them titties all the time. Oh, you're in for some shit now.
The funny thing is that he said that she covered tits with a blanket. She was wearing a dress.
Well, basically. Well, I mean, Jesse wears dresses that look like blankets.
Fair enough, yeah.
Anyhoodle.
You don't make sense. Continue ignoring me, though, if you want. Too much of that, and I will just look for someone that wants to be real with me. You ignore me, though, if you want. Too much of that, and I will just look for someone that wants to be real with me.
You are annoying.
You've been ignoring me all this time, Jamie. Do you really think that's good and good for us? I want to know if you want us to work things out and get back together. If not, then tell me, and I will leave you alone and look for someone else to be with. Because I'm not going to keep doing this if you're going to let our plans for a future together just go down the shitter. No answer doesn't bode well either.
Hi. Hello. Can you hear me? Hi. My headset didn't work for a second there. I didn't notice it.
It's always such a letdown when the real Lorne gets on the phone. Because I mean, Patrick could do the sheetrock talk, and it would at least be entertaining. Once Lorne, it's just such a personality drain. Like you can actually feel it drain from the goal. Hey. Hey.
Oh, great. What's this idiot got to say?
How are you?
Well, right off the bat, let's start with this. You also for a picture. I send it. And now you are sitting there complaining I didn't show you my tits. Mm-hmm. Are you serious right now?
I'm curious why you're hiding them to me. I mean, you're so free with showing everybody else.
You are unbelievable. But
Jamie, I'm not playing any head games with you at all.
Yeah.
You can't want to, you can't. I can't believe that you can't figure out why I wonder why. I can't believe that you can't figure out why I wonder why you are so free to show. I can't believe you can't figure out why I.
He just keeps starting back over.
Yeah, he's going to get it out.
He just keeps starting back over. And you just keep repeating the same thing. But he's going to get it out. Fuck you. He's going to get the last word in.
Wonder why you feel so free to show him to Will, Maggie Joe, Maggie Joe's fiance, but you don't show him to the one guy that you want to spend your life with. But you don't want to show him to the one guy that you want to spend your life with. Huh?
Why were you expecting to see them there?
I wasn't. I didn't even pay attention to it last night. I didn't pay attention till today. It looks like she got a blanket around. Because when I was looking at the picture today, I was like, why does she have a blanket around herself? So last night when we first got on the phone, and Will, last night when we were on the phone and Will came in, did you have a blanket around you?
Nope. Tips were just out your swinging. Tip again?
Yeah.
Before you put, I bet Will wrapped that fucking blanket around you, didn't he? And he made sure to grab a handful when he did. Tell me about it, Jamie. Tell me he wrapped that fucking fleece blanket around you and grabbed them both. That fucker was tuning in Tokyo, wasn't he? Tell me, Jamie, was that fucker tuning in Tokyo?
Is Will still there? Honking your boobs?
Was he squeezing them and making honking noises? Tell me, Jamie. I fucking know. TLI?
Yeah.
Oh, he's pooping. Are you pooping?
Yes. Okay. No, I'm not pooping. I'm here.
My Lord.
I'm seriously asking you. Because of what transpired with the spank.
Transpired?
It is fucking pathetic. It is extremely pathetic, Jamie, because this is not something that we should have to deal with.
Yeah.
When you have a significant other and you want to be with somebody, you don't go showing your body off to another.
Real, and this is what you are going with.
Jimmy, you're not even paying attention to me.
Come on, Jimmy.
When you have a significant other and you want to be with somebody, you don't go showing your body off to another guy all the time.
True.
I sent you a
you don't go.
You wanted that so you
only some of the time.
Tits. Really?
No, Jamie, damn it.
Yeah.
Why do you know?
You know, Jamie, it's the principle. It's the fucking principle. For every guy who gets to see your titties online, Lorne, you get to see him twice. You don't love those guys online, but you love Lorne. And if Lorne's going to make sex inside of your body, you're going to let Lorne make sex inside of your body because that body belongs to Lorne. But hold on. I guess I get what you're going to say. How's that fair? You own that dick. Okay,
it's a fair chance exchange.
It's a give and take, guys.
Yeah.
It's a mutually beneficial relationship. You're gonna show Lorne your titties when he wants to see him, and if he wants you to bend over and show him butthole, girl, bend over and show that butthole. Why are you being so selfish with the man? He will show you his butthole. He's got no problem with it. You're being selfish, Jamie. You.
Now let me ask you guys. This is common, right? You know, when you're in a relationship and you're telling them, how dare you show your tits to everyone else but me?
It is for me, yeah.
Yeah, no. I've been in, like, at least three relationships like this, yes.
Yeah. Why is everyone else? But like, literally everyone else was getting to see them but me. So like, yeah, right. It's common. The fact that he might think she's a sex worker.
Yeah.
And he's supposed to be okay with being with the sex worker, but this is what he's getting mad about? Someone seeing her tits and him not getting to see them? And then making demands on
the baseline. That's a pretty low bar. You're setting. You're going to get mad every time.
What's the blanket wrapped around you when Will came in the room? I wonder how much time he spent thinking about that. If the blanket wasn't on, how long was Will in the room before you wrapped it around yourself? Was it a doctor situation? Did he walk in and you were turned around and you put your hands on your hips and said, what are you doing here? Or did you get a full eyeful? Did you let him eye fuck you before you wrapped the blanket around you?
He knows deep down there was nothing clinical about what went down
there. Yeah, no, there was hanky panky and tomfoolery going on. That's what was going on.
Listening to me. You're not even hearing what I'm saying. When Will came into your room last night, that wasn't for work.
Okay.
I wasn't naked, you idiot.
They were practicing.
That's what I asked you.
No, you didn't.
You did. I did.
You asked why I didn't show you my tits in the picture.
No, Jamie.
Yes.
What I asked was, listen.
Hold on.
You don't go banging for Will or anyone.
You weren't asking. Something I just noticed about the pic you sent me last night. You wrapped a blanket around you so I couldn't see your tits, but you don't mind if Will and MJ and her fiance see you naked, but not me.
The fucking monotone.
Wow.
Exactly.
The monotone.
Exactly
when
what
like
I
mean, but monologue will get me every time. And I just see your tits, and I will not see your tits.
But tell me, it doesn't sound almost exactly like him when he's doing his drywall talk.
Yeah,
there's not really that much of a difference. Or if you've ever listened to anything I've done with Nuggies, and they go off on anything about anything, it's like, you know what I mean? It's like still just that it might not sound as monotone, but in your mind, it just kind of all mixes in there and does nothing. You know what I'm saying?
He spams answers the way the robot does, but he knows how to do it in real life. He just keeps starting over his same response if he doesn't get what he wants to hear.
Yeah, that actually reminds me of that. It actually reminds me of something, guys. I think we should.
And what is that?
Hi, I'm Nuggets, and I do things. I talk like this, like my voice is very fake. I have no acting skills and no talent. Digital art is not talent because 5-year-olds can do the same thing. Beep boop bop. I'm a robot. I have no talent and sound.
It was like
just
the ultimate
like
crossover
I
right
am
here.
Acting in an 80s movie.
Yeah, so that's what that reminds me of.
Did Jesse just confirm Nuggets was the robot?
Yes, yeah. I don't know if it's been confirmed yet, Reborn, but hold on, I can make it official. Make it official.
Breaking news. I'm Gary Glipstone. Here's Wes Most with a special report.
Guys, it has just been confirmed from the most worst news desk by one Mr. Bjorn Heel Bjorn Armstrong that the robot is in fact the untalented, angry child, evil little McNug Nugs. Hillborn, thank you for confirming that.
Yeah, no problem, anytime.
Yeah. Boop.
I was asking Jamie, listen to me. You want the answer? Listen to me. I was asking you, why are you feeling so free to show them to Will and Maggie Jo and her fiance, but you don't feel free to show them to the one guy that you want to be married to?
Who says I do?
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, that you don't make sense.
I make perfect sense.
It does not make sense. I mean, it's fun. I'm fine. You don't want to show him.
Not making sense.
Jamie, I'm fine. You don't want to show him to me until we're in person. That's fine. I just don't understand that.
About it. He's not complaining. He's just bringing it up as a subject.
Oh,
he's not complaining. Yeah, right. He just wants you to know a lesser man would be bothered by it. That's all he's saying.
Oh, okay. When you put it like that, it makes it all the more. Yeah.
He's not a lesser man, though, but he's saying a lesser man, a more beta man, if you would, would probably notice something like that and want to know why they're not seeing titties, too. That's all.
Someone with bluer eyes than me would think this.
someone with bluer eyes and a genie fetish would probably be really upset. I'm not that man.
You wouldn't have said anything if you didn't.
I don't understand it. But I can respect you not wanting to show me until we're together. I can respect that. It's just I don't understand it. I love you, so I'm not asking you to send me.
After you accuse me of not being real and you wonder why I didn't flash my tits for you, are you serious, Al?
Al? Who's Al?
Oh, who the fuck is Al?
Capital
L.
Al. What do you call me?
Yeah,
he likes that. He loves that.
No. Does he like it? It sounds to me like he's trying to figure out what's going on. Like, who the fuck are you talking
to? I mean, part that, but like anything that's like a pet name, anything adjacent to a pet name, he's going to be like, oh, yeah, he.
Well, yeah,
as hard as he can get right now.
Right.
I mean, well, I came up with a pet name for Pickles, and she loved it. So let's see if he likes this one.
L.
Oh. He did like it.
Oh, shit.
It's for little.
You can be so funny.
Think about not making sense. Don't giggle out of what I said.
What? You come up with some shit sometimes and it's just funny.
It's the first letter of your name.
Yeah, it's not like the robot fat fingered at all and just added an extra letter in there or something.
L. He's so happy about that. Call me W. And I'm like, that's so cute the way you call me W. Where'd you get that?
Jamie, I love you.
Right, so you going to stop dodging and answer?
I didn't hear all your questions. I'm sorry. I got my mind was.
You got lost in the sauce.
Somewhere else.
It's easy to do.
He's lost in love.
Well, no, I'm not awful. I just didn't hear your question because I had a question for you, and I didn't get to hear all of your question.
What?
You sit and bitch that I never hear what you say.
Well, I think it's sometimes you don't understand what I'm saying.
That's it.
Sometimes you take it offensively and sometimes you don't. It's no different with some of the things that you say. Some of the things that you say. Just like the question I just had that I asked you about.
I told you it was about, a rough till you accuse me of not being real and you wonder why I didn't flash my tits for you. Are you serious?
Jamie, I told you I didn't understand that.
How disrespectful.
Jesus. You're just rude. You're still trying to find shit wrong with me.
And degrading.
He said as he tries to find a reason to be upset.
I was degrading, Jamie.
No, he's not trying to find a reason. See, that's where you're wrong, Tila. He's not trying to find a reason to be upset. He's waiting for her to give him a reason not to be upset. That's all.
Right.
That's all. He's giving her a chance. He's giving her a chance to calm him down, to let him not be innocent. Well, I mean, she didn't show him her titties. That's all the guilt you need right there. Why would Will get to see him? Why does everyone else get to look at him? And he doesn't.
Well, maybe if he had a fucking internet connection, wasn't a pedophile, he could watch her live stream.
Okay, but if ifs and buts were candies and nuts, we'd all have a wonderful Christmas.
I forgot about the ifs and buts being candies and nuts. That was my mistake.
You obviously don't understand the law, but the ifs and buts arguments.
We were engaged. When we were engaged, you still didn't hide your tits from Will.
That's a sentence right there.
That you was not engaged.
When we were engaged, you wouldn't stop showing your tits to Will. Why were you engaged?
How many times have I said that? Same exact thing.
To your fiance.
You still wouldn't stop showing your tits to Will.
Jamie, I told you. I respect you not wanting to show me your tits till we're together.
Stop cheating on me.
That's it. I respect you
not wanting to show me your tits until we're together, but I just didn't understand why. It's like you showed me your ass and your pussy, but you don't want to show me your tits. It doesn't make sense to me.
Hey, Lauren, ass and pussy trump titties. You can see titties. You can see titties on Cinemax. They ain't showing no pussy on Cinemax. So I'm just saying, in terms of sexting, what you're getting, if you're seeing Kulo and Coochie, don't be complaining about them titties. Guys, are you with me here?
I know exactly.
Hell yeah. Yeah.
You guys heard it here first.
Yeah, we're all on the same page.
TLI likes them Coochies and Kulos. Can you say that? Like, hi, I'm TLI, and I love Coochies and Kulos.
Hi, everyone. TLI here. I love Coochies and Kulos. Have a good night.
Everyone's leaving now.
All right, guys, that's the stream. Thank you.
Wrap it up.
Have a nice one, everyone.
Drive safe, everyone.
Yeah.
Well, you don't have to explain it. Just forget it.
Hey, stop avoiding the fact that you accused me yet again last night. I'm not real, but I'm the one getting grilled.
Jamie, how do I explain this stuff to you?
I can show or not show you anything I want, and it doesn't matter if you understand.
Well, that's what you think. He does not agree.
No. How do I explain it to you that it's not in a normal here? You're down there. You've yet to even show a sign of wanting to come up here. And I want to tell you that my probation officer is wanting to talk to you or something like that.
The probation officer's like, Lauren, listen, the pictures of her asshole and her pussy, wonderful. But where are the tits? Lauren, I got to see the tits if you want to get off probation. So that's what it's about.
Yeah. Guys, can't confirm she's real. This is just current. Unless we see titties. Sorry.
I need to see her titties to match them to the national database. Yeah, okay. It's like fingerprints. That makes sense. Let me see them brief prints. And then they match them up and they're like, actually, this is Kayla. This is Kayla Moore. You're good. You're good.
You don't want to talk to her. She's got to make sure that you know all about me. And she's got to know information about you, but you don't want to give it to her. It's not a normal situation.
What about this is abnormal? Go ahead, robot.
As much as I wish it was, it's not. And the things that I told you that was said in my class, I was literally telling you what was said. Honey, I was literally telling you what was said in class because you're always asking me, and this time I told you exactly what we talked about. Because we don't usually talk about you that much, but when I started talking about you the time before that, well, now they're asking me more questions about us. Huh? Jamie, a probation officer is on me to know about you.
Hey, Lorne, remember when you sent those disgusting texts to me and we broke up? You told me that I wasn't real. Then you said, what, Lorne? You didn't mean it and you'd never do it again. Then what happened?
Jamie, remember when you keep going back on things in, from the past, too?
Stop deflecting.
Shit, dump truck man.
Stop deflecting.
Christmas tree.
Is he just bringing up a list of things he lied about as a reason to say that you should stop accusing him of lying?
Yeah, listing times he lied to say you should probably stop bringing up me lying. Sound strategy.
Stop bringing up my proven pattern of behavior of lying to you as a way to call me out for lying to you right now. That's really unfair to me. You guys should start with a clean slate every time.
You wake up in the morning and it's like Groundhog Day. It's just nothing happened.
Just nothing happened. You're just still in love like a fucking TV sitcom on season 27. Just going through the motions.
I'm not deflecting. I'm telling you that you do the same thing.
Same fucking thing.
Lorne, you promised you'd never do it again.
Okay, and you said you'd stop doing that too.
Oh, the old rubber and glue.
You still do it too.
Nah.
Yep. He's now what, Jamie?
It'd be nice if both of us would just get away from doing it and move forward without looking back.
And look, another promise broken. I didn't promise anything, Lorne.
I didn't say you promised. I said you said you wouldn't.
Yeah.
I didn't say that either.
I'm not going to respond to that. It would be nice if we both could get past everything that has happened in the past and move forward. Jamie, I've tried, but you keep going back to the past again.
I think these kids are going to make it.
They're going to, yeah, they're just working it out.
Yeah.
But for this to work, we've got to get past the past, and we've got to move forward.
Yeah, past the
past. I'm showing a repeated pattern of behavior, Lorne, and you don't listen. You just deflect because you don't have an answer.
Jamie, I've got an answer. Let's stop talking about the past. Let's stop going back to the past. You know how much I would care if we stopped going back to the past?
It would do a world of
good. It includes me, too. I'm not just saying you.
Right. So you call me fake. Say you won't do it again. Then you did it again last night.
Jamie, you've... how can you not understand what I'm dealing with? I've tried to explain it to you so many times.
I can't mention last night. Is that the past?
Mention last night if you want, because we're talking about it right now.
Oh.
But I'm trying to explain to you.
Something else you don't understand is that I told you we needed to work up to a relationship, and your response to that is saying okay, but then asking me to marry you, followed by a rant about how I'm fake.
Wow.
But Jamie, you've got me all confused.
It's your fault.
You seriously have me very confused right now.
Confused.
Because you sent me that picture last night. Okay, there is.
I noticed Lorne uses confusion a lot for insecurity.
Yes.
Like anytime he's insecure is what it is. So he's going to say, well, you've got me all confused. There's really no confusion here. Jamie doesn't give a shit about you.
Yeah.
Like, this isn't a real relationship. And no one would be confused about that. So you're insecure because there'll be those moments of clarity where you'll start thinking about the situation and thinking about all the things that don't make sense. And then you start talking yourself out of it. So what he wants Jamie to do is it's reassure him that this is a real relationship and she is a real person. And the one way that she can do that, I mean, could she send an ID? Could she book a plane ticket? Absolutely. Those things would all work. But Jamie, show me your fucking tits. Just show me your fucking tits.
Yeah, I mean, it seems much more logical to just ask for the tits than like.
That's all the. If you and this, a lot of people don't know this. You want to fly and you leave ID at home. You get a left titty and they'll let you on the plane. It's guys.
There's confusion.
He loves going to confusion.
You're not wanting to send me pictures the whole time, and only since.
What was that?
He likes using confusion for a lot of things. That's why he ripped Betty off. That's why he got caught in a sting. Confusion.
Well, he was, yeah. Yeah, he was confused about all the things. And he just needs to figure out what that confusion thing, though. You're going to see a lot of great things come from Lorne.
Absolutely. He's going to be the second coming.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
No, you're good.
How much time would you spend per day, like replying to messages from Lorne? Or would it depend?
I would assume the robot got texted all day long, every day. And
sorry, yeah.
Sometimes kayfabe never dies. He would text all day long, and then depending on how the day went, he would either get mad and send those texts you heard at the start, where it's like, oh, I guess there's no time for me today, or he would be like super happy. It would be nonstop, but the robot would give him like K's and cools unless the robot was fired up, and then it would be like paragraphs of it'd be some time invested in the text. It just depends.
Would the robot have a good idea of what was going to set Lorne off, or would it be pretty just random?
It's hard to say. Like the yes and no. There were things that the robot thought would set him off and would work. There were other times where it didn't, or like that thing wouldn't set him off until weeks later for some reason. He'd just hold on to it. Were other times like the robot would say something offhanded, not thinking anything of it, and he wouldn't shut up about it for a week.
You so said, kind of,
yeah.
So kind of like Jesse, where I would go in with these ideas of what was going to piss her off, and it wouldn't work, and then 3 weeks later she'd be super mad about it. Or, but all it would always go back to Nuggies, her Xavier.
Yes, it's always Xavier. Yeah,
because you talked to Jesse once, and
oh god, Jesus, did you really?
Yeah. I was trying to get Reborn involved since July.
This wouldn't work. Yeah, I talked to her for like she talked about Nuggets and Vex for like 40 minutes, and then said, "So what did you want to talk about?" And I was like, "You told me to call you."
He was like, "Jesus, I'm on the phone with her. She won't stop talking about Vex and Nuggets."
Oh my god, she just wanted to vent.
Yeah, for the 400th time.
Vex. Yeah, about the same thing again.
Jamie, yeah, you gotta let me talk.
Wes, you know, you'd think of these ideas. No, you're good.
What if you didn't know what?
You think of these ideas and these plans, and you're like, "This is gonna be fire," and then, or like a banger, and then it goes nowhere, and then you say some offhanded comment. She's, you know,
just something that'll surprise the shit out of you that you like didn't expect would have any impact at all. But yeah, I would plan these big things, and they would just go nowhere. But then I mentioned fucking a rowboat, and then she was going to go make a community post and do a stream about it. So you just never know.
What I'm saying, you've got to hear it. Almost the whole year that we've been together, you've only sent me a limited amount of pictures.
Oh, like you were listening to me earlier.
Yeah, I was listening to you earlier. I just happened to not hear that because I was in the process of asking you a question. That's too. Cool.
No.
Okay, can I talk now?
Sorry, I got caught up on something.
Smart ass.
Dipshit.
Okay.
Sometimes you'll be cute and playful about it. Sometimes you'll get pissed.
Years really we've been random. Together.
Yeah.
Yeah, it just depends. Do you think he has any level of of bipolar? Like, did you see any of that with him? Would he go super hot and cold?
Yes, there was a lot of mood swings. There's a lot of like back and forth where, I mean, there's a couple calls where you're hearing him like cry and then just stop and start yelling and then cry again or then laugh or just mid screen go, who's calling me?
Jamie, you don't know. Like, you know.
Did he ever say, any hoodle? Any hoodle?
I wish he did.
Start singing the any hole song.
He's a limited amount of pitchers, and you never wanted to send me, and you never wanted to send me on the spot pitchers, and you never like sending me pitchers. And yes, but you didn't like sending me pitchers. And it's like whenever I asked for you to send. It was like whenever I asked for you to send me a picture, it was like twisting an arm. It got to the point where I was like, Christ, if I asked her to send. It got to the point where it's like, Christ, if I ask her to send me a picture, she's just going to bitch me out about it. So what's the point of asking? My probation officer and the counselor. Well, said you don't even have a picture of her. Like, yeah, I do have a picture of her. And somehow they seem to forget that I.
My perspective instead of just you for once in a year.
Huh?
Right, so let's look at it from my perspective instead of just you for once in a year.
Okay. Use your perspective.
I'm sure Jamie's typing a fucking paragraph right now. It's going to be a minute.
Yeah. I like when she takes all this time, then it'll be like, fuck you.
Yeah. What? I like when it's this break and then she starts talking and doesn't stop. And Lauren interrupts it halfway through, and then she has to fire it back up. The whole paragraph starts back over because he didn't listen.
Yeah, what was the robot using to do this?
It was a text-to-speech app. That's it.
Oh, okay.
Just on the phone, just tapping. Hence the fat fingers and the you know, misspelling sometimes.
Yeah, that's a lot of work.
I mean, to keep up with this, you know, dolt's mind, yes. Because if you don't keep him on topic, he's going to go off on three separate subjects before you get it out.
Because you can just get one of these, and then you can be like angry black guy. Watch.
What's up, Lauren? This is Tyrone from the Air Force.
See? Now I'm Tyrone from the Air Force. We used to serve together. Who, Tyrone?
That's an incredible.
That's right, Lauren. Tell that bitch to send you them titties.
Tyrone's the one who tells Lauren when he needs to get them titties.
That explains where he learned that from. Yeah,
he learned the foul talk. He didn't learn the foul talk from his brother.
I learned the foul talk from Tyrone.
Yeah, I was like, yo, tell that bitch she ain't sending you no titties. What the fuck wrong with her, Lauren? Lauren, I'm just saying, if I was you, motherfucker, if I was you. I tell the bitch just like this. You gonna let Will see them titties? Girl, you will let me see them titties. See what I did there?
And then Lauren will be on board.
Yeah, I mean, that does sound very convincing.
Who wouldn't go for that? There's wordplay. And a deep black voice? Come on.
People love that.
It's still playing, by the way.
Lot of type.
What? Wow. And he's just sitting there, not saying a word.
He's probably like playing with his dink.
It's Stewie. He's stewing and jerking off.
Mm-hmm. You think he even remembers what he asked?
I guess she's still typing.
No, she's busy showing both her titties.
Yeah, she just had to snap a new photo of her tits for everyone to see, except Lauren.
That's really fucked up. That's selfish of her. I want to see your tits, baby.
Baby.
Like, this would be I can't stand being on the phone. So this would be but he looks forward to this.
Oh yeah.
I mean, I know for the robot, it's content. But like for Lauren, this is his quantity time that he looks forward to, and he could sit here in silence just like this because he knows at least the robot's probably not fucking right now.
Yeah, as long as they're on the phone, there's no way they could be cheating on him
because he'd hear it.
Right. There's no.
You hear the robot. The robot will be typing. Oh, 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 just like that. You're banging. Who's? Yeah, who are you having sex? Is there something wrong?
Oh my. Oh my.
Oh my.
This man child demonstrantly and constantly reassured over things in his mind every other day. When I do send a photo, it's followed immediately with a demand for more, and it's quite fucked up if I don't. Or he doesn't like the lighting, or he doesn't like my makeup on, or he wants a different angle. Hell, look at night. You called me fake and accused me of lying, so I sent one, and yet again it wasn't good enough because you start bitching that my tits weren't in it. You are never satisfied. You are a black hole. I'm not going to feed into your bullshit.
It's a little rude.
That's why.
Honey, I'm fine that you didn't show me tits. I just didn't understand. But you want to wait till we're together to show me tits, that I respect it. I told you that. So I don't have a problem. It just sends me.
That's why you complaining.
Well, no, I weren't complaining. I just I didn't understand.
That's all.
Because it's like the whole time you haven't wanted to show me. I mean, even Will and Maggie Joe said something once.
I know Lauren won't respect this, but if you respect someone's decision, then you don't question it. That's what respecting their decision means.
Crazy.
That's what the respect of the decision means. So by saying, yeah, I respect your decision, I just don't understand it. It means it means right there, buddy, that you don't accept her decision, because there'd be no reason to question it. If she doesn't want to send you titas, she doesn't have to. She can send them to you when she's ready, or she can never send them to you. And really, the only person that you control in that scenario is you. If the fact that you're not seeing titties, it bothers you to the point where you want to yell and scream, then this isn't the person for you. And if you bring it up in a calm, respectful manner, like, hey, I'd love to see more of your body. I feel like maybe I'm not getting enough of it. I don't get to see you, so I'd like to see some more of your body. Girls, send me some of them titties, please. You know, I'd love to see them titties sometimes. And if she's not down for that, then this is not the relationship for you. It's just that simple.
He knows. I thought you were going to say you had two words for her, but yeah, definitely.
What were the two words?
Suck it.
Romantic.
They said, "Why, you have nice tits?" I was like, oh, "I wouldn't know."
Quote, the things you do don't make sense, because I didn't show my tits in the photo last night.
I'm sorry that I mentioned. Finally, I'm Jamie sorry that you got offended by me mentioning that. It wasn't meant
to sound like it. Yeah.
Right, so out of all I said, that's what you laser in on.
No. It's not like that I'm looking for more, Jamie. I'm not trying to bitch about things on it.
Here's a perfect example.
He should write a poem about seeing the titties.
That probably would have got some titty pics.
Right?
Or if he wrote a song about it. Oh,
titties. Well, he would call them, he'd call them breast or bosoms. He'd call them breast because a lot of things rhyme with breast. because he can run.
I sent you a picture of my pussy one night after you grilled me for it. What was your response? Send me another one with the light on further away.
So picky.
Uh-oh.
Right?
What do you want me to say to that? I had a hard time seeing that.
Couldn't just say thank you.
And I'll tell you this, the photo definitely wasn't some
Photoshopped. Well, I did say thank you, but I wanted...
It wasn't some, like, doctored photo of, like, a plastic vagina. There's no way that's what it was.
No.
I'm sure it wasn't. Why would... that would be a trolling if they did that. So, yeah. And so he immediately he wants to see it again, but with the light, with more light.
Yeah, he needs to see it at a better angle because it was like flipped upside down and kind of dark, you know, saturation down or whatever.
Right, just so it couldn't get too much scrutiny.
But it, I mean, but it sounds like the hamburger from when I was listening to that call where his mom gave him the hamburger. And he just needs to complain to her that it doesn't take. Now I'm going to say, because I couldn't type it at the time, but I get what he was saying, dude. My mom, you know, like growing up poor, she would get these hamburgers. Oh, they tasted like gas station hamburgers. It's not like, it's not 100% ground beef. Like, you know that. And so I'm sure that's what he meant. But how are you going to complain for some free food that your mom just brought to you? But I don't want to complain, but that's like the shittiest part about it. I don't want to, you know, thank you, but this doesn't taste like a hamburger. It's good, but it doesn't taste like a hamburger. It's just a shitty thing.
I can't really see it. Can you get a better light? Can you get better light?
But the phone close and get a better light on it.
Yeah.
Just fucking beggars and choosers and selfish people. Selfish people always calling out other people for being selfish.
Yeah. Lorne is the ultimate beggar and chooser.
He is.
Mm-hmm. You always wanted me to be honest. You're always wanting me to be honest.
I think there's a difference between like not lying to someone and asking for better lighting on the pussy pics.
Right.
I think what he meant is saying thank you would have been a lie. I would say thank you, but I'm not trying to lie. Thank you.
I wasn't do grateful.
I want you to do better. I need a better picture. I got 20% hard from that. Get the light closer. We might be up to 30-35%, Jamie. It's up to you. How hard do you want my dick?
And keep in mind, his max is 40, so like 30.
Exactly. Now the ball's in your court. What percentage of my penis do you want inside of you, Jamie? Up to 40%, please. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Puts a whole new paint job on things.
Yeah, that's sex right there.
Now, I'm not stopping with that bullshit because you're always on me about it. That's why you call me liar.
Not because he's a liar.
That's why you call me liar.
You are a liar.
See?
You can't get away from that.
Got him.
He's thinking of something brilliant to say. You know it.
Jamie, I love you, and I really want us to work out.
Brilliant.
Oh. I knew it. That's brilliant.
We got to stop finding things wrong with each other.
We.
And we got to stop going back to the past all the time.
I feel like you forget that last night I expressed my feelings and your response was, quote, thanks for wasting my time, and you are fake. What makes you think that things are okay?
You expressed your feelings. You told me you didn't want me never to call you again.
That did answer the question.
Yeah, after you wouldn't listen to how I feel.
All right. I'm sorry.
Here's a question.
I'm listening.
Can I get a ride home?
I'm listening right now. I'm going to listen to everything you say.
Stop with that. If you cared, you would have listened then.
I was listening then.
Right.
It's because I didn't retain it very well. That's the way that I work. There's not much I can do about that. You know that by now. You've known me long enough.
He's blaming Jamie for him not being smart enough to retain and understand things.
Yeah.
That is a whole different level of gaslighting. It's like, so if she says, like, I should have known. Yeah, you know what, Lauren? I blame myself. And he can be like, finally we're on the same page. Yeah, yes, absolutely. We both blame you. Now, may I see your titties? It's your own fault, Jamie, for expecting more out of me.
Yeah, this is romance.
Dude, it's getting there.
Because you didn't listen. Anyway. My question. Why do you want to be with me?
I love you. Jamie, we've been together for almost a year. I remember how we were. I'm answering you. If you give me a minute.
Oh, he's working on a speech.
I remember how we were when we first got together.
Jamie, I remember how we were when we first got together. See that? See what a difference the tone change makes? Mm-hmm. Now you try it.
Try what?
Are you even paying attention to what's going on? Are you messaging Steve McCray? What's going on over there?
I am paying attention. I just you know.
What did I say?
I'm not. I don't know. I'm not going to. I'm not listening to your every word. I'm not hanging on your every word. You know what? You know.
This is why I know we need a palette. It's my own fault for expecting him to remember to think that he can understand things. That one's really on me.
It's not all call and response here. I'm not a little donkey parrot, you know.
No, you're absolutely right.
Once upon a time, you were the man.
Now you're the manager.
You used to run these concrete streets with an iron fist.
Now you reserve the corner conference room with a dry erase marker.
Life came at you fast.
Now it's time for you to come harder. Come all over this city's face.
Responsibility made you step back. Now it's time to step up.
With hints of leather, bacon, and gunpowder, we bring the man.
And you bring the plan.
Because your days belong to the office.
But your nights were made to step up.
Right on. That was good. That was really good.
That's a commercial.
And good news, guys, we have a new live read to do tonight for Step Up.
Oh, thank God.
I think you guys, and Heelborn, you actually have a part in this one.
Oh, cool.
I was hoping he would, yeah.
Yeah, you have a part in this one, Heelborn. So I think you're gonna really enjoy that.
I can't wait.
And I remember how we can be. Every relationship goes through hard times.
Like, you're going back on that.
I am, because you know that I didn't mean that stuff. You know that it's out of frustration and being upset and the odd situations. And
you meant every fucking word.
Strange. No, I didn't mean every fucking word, and you know I didn't.
She just said you did.
That's why you say it every time you are upset. Clearly on your mind, liar. Was so great about before.
Pose. It hasn't been wanting to spend time with each other. It's been me wanting to spend time with you, but you wanting to spend time on the computer or with Maggie Joe or doing what the fuck ever, but you're most of the time you're on the computer.
He really has no problem just sitting and waiting for her to type out an answer. It's crazy.
Yeah, yeah, he'll sit there all day.
Good God, yeah. Like, as long as she's on the phone, it doesn't matter. Truly.
It's quality time.
Oh, I think Wes is now not in the call. I think we might just be sitting, okay?
We are.
Now yes. I'm seeing what happened. Wow. Well, how are you? How are you doing, Hillborn? How's your life?
I'm good. How are you? My life's going pretty good.
I'm doing pretty good. Yeah. Have you caught up on One Piece? Are you all caught up?
Oh yeah. Are you?
Oh boy. I'm almost caught up. I've got like two chapters to read, but I've really been enjoying it.
Yeah, the new arc has been fire. Like it. Every chapter.
I'm like, shocked by his ability to with the consistency. It's hard to beat. I don't know any other story that's been like that long running and that consistent with the quality.
No, I agree. Yeah.
What are we talking about?
We're talking about One Piece. Where were you?
I got kicked. I don't know what happened.
Oh boy.
It might have been the step up people.
I know who it was.
Tell me after.
Sure, you're gonna see exactly. Less moderators around.
I thought maybe the Cornbill Mafia had finally caught up to me.
Oh right, yeah. Yes, I forgot about that. Yeah, the mythic.
All right, can you guys see the screen again?
I see a wheel spinning.
Yes.
There we go. Happening.
No.
Rip.
Bikini that.
That was.
Oh, weren't getting used to. All I could fit. Jamie. All I could fit was you walking around in a string bikini and showing your ass off all over the place.
Don't you find these conversations to be miserable every night?
I do.
Me too.
I tried so hard to get past them and get so we can start talking good again.
Right.
But the small past gets brought up.
Why would you want to still be part of this, Lauren?
Forget about the past and concentrate on the future.
I hear his siblings live. Well, in the
because
future.
Think about how fucked up his past is. Mm. Exactly. So far in the future. They can't. Ralph and Lori can't. I love that call because his mom gets so fed up with him after that bullshit. Ralph and Lori can't. They can't live in the past because they screwed too many people over.
Well, because he gets so mad, and she's just like trying to go to bed, and he's like, "They're pieces of shit, mom!" Like throwing a tantrum, and then at like 10:30 at night, he's like, "Jackass!"
Like he wants her to say it too. Admit it. Just fucking agree with me. They're pieces of shit.
Yeah, tell me that your other kids aren't me. Your pieces of shit, please.
And then what does he say? Or just like, who does he compare him to? Dale?
Just like your ex-husband. To someone.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. The ex-husband. So she's like, okay, fine. Like, we're done here. Like, goodbye. Like, I'm not going to talk about my ex-husband now, too.
Sitting in my chair. Great son.
What?
Hello, Mother Dale.
That's why I keep saying it.
Because you continue to act so much the same way, then want to reset when you royally fuck up.
I keep saying it's going to be so much different when we're face to face.
Is it?
That's what I always wonder. How different can it be face to face?
Well, he's making a lot of promises about face to face, like, you know, the quitting, the smoking, the drink, like everything will be complete. He'll change his entire personality and lifestyle the second she walks in the door, if he's to be believed.
He's going to stop being the most insecure man in the history of the world. Like,
just undo decades.
I mean, I think
of insecurity.
Doesn't it kind of feed the whole theory, though, that he's never had an actual relationship because he's only had online relationships. So for him, all the stuff that he feels, all the insecurity, all the jealousy, that'll be fixed as soon as there's an actual woman there proving to him. Especially now, like, any woman that's going to be out there with him now would be giving a lot. There'd be a lot of sacrificing involved. So he has it in his head that as soon as that happens, then he'll do anything he can to, well, in his head, he'll do anything he can to make that woman happy. He'll quit smoking. He'll, you know, put drywall up. He'll put insulation inside the walls and he'll stop pissing in the yard. He'll do all those things because that'll be perfect.
Complete 180. Yeah.
Yep. Just a new man.
The fact that he considers Paula one of his real relationships does tell me that he has
very
few real ones. Because that one really was him just like showing up to a bar where his favorite bartender worked and like following her around all night and then calling it a date.
Sex story.
He's nuts. Yeah, the sex story, right.
That sex story is so sad.
It's weird. Yeah, I don't know if she was encouraging it. She might have been, who knows, you know, like in the way that, you know, any bartender would.
Right. Well, I mean, she
cocktail waitress, yeah.
Like, even if she went over.
He's an idiot.
He says she went over there after a fight. Yo,
I don't believe that either.
Well, I mean, but is it possible? Was there some, like, you ain't ever had, like, I'm saying, you ain't ever had, okay. It's possible. there are revenge bangs where you will, like, people do this. This is a
thing. I'm going to bang that creepy guy from the bar, Derek.
Yeah, you know what? Yeah. You don't want to show me attention? I'm going to go bang that future pedophile. And then, but then he come pick her up. That's the part that doesn't make sense. Then he comes and picks her up.
Right, then he rolls up in the Corvette. He's like, come on, babe, I forgive you.
With just blaring, blaring Sexy Boy by Shawn Michaels.
Right, exactly.
Just
that's
the
song.
Sexy boy. And she runs out of Lauren's apartment and hops in his car.
I'm sorry, Lauren. Like, God damn it.
The fucking heartbreak kid did it again.
Can I tell you a romantic thought Lauren had with the robot?
Does it involve the heartbreak kid, Shawn Michaels?
I mean, you could. Can tell me at the end that we could probably incorporate it somehow, but he said that he wanted to fall asleep with his penis inside of her, and then they would both be dreaming about themselves having sex somehow, like, linked together, I don't know, and then they would start fucking in their dreams and then fuck in real life.
Wow, that's like Inception.
That sounds like the kind of idea you have when you're on E. And it sounds like it makes a lot of sense at the time.
We're gonna fall asleep inside of each other. We're gonna fuck our dreams. We're gonna fuck in real life.
It's the
circle of fuck, girl. You ain't know about the circle of fuck. And then later you're like, what was I thinking about?
Yeah, but he does that dead sober. Great.
So yeah, the answer is absolutely. It absolutely involves the heartbreak kid, Shawn Michaels.
It does.
He's in the
corner watching in the dream.
Yeah,
part of the dream. In 90s era, mid 90s era, Shawn Michaels.
He's doing a line of coke on the table, watching him
just spinning around, and he's got like mirrors on his on his outfit. Yeah, it's that Shawn Michaels.
And this is not the first time he's wanted to fall asleep with, like, being inside of someone's vagina. That's like a running theme for him. Yeah, he's coming to the decoy. This has been a decade. Yeah, you know.
Well, let's stop calling. Well, the decoy, but now he's with the actual. He was with the actual.
Right.
Person,
so he's vindicated. It's all fine.
All the things he didn't get to do the child decoy, he gets to do the person who pretended to be that child. So
yeah, this is the perfect situation for him if it was real.
I mean, how would probation not be cool with that?
Yeah, right. Probation's got to be loving this.
Could you see the Dateline follow up on that? 20 years ago, we profiled him on To Catch a Predator. Now, that decoy and that predator married and living in Maine. Stone Phillips reports. And then, like, he's like,
thanks,
out,
Dan.
He's out in Cornville. To some of you, this may look like a shitty street fair, but to Cornville, Maine. And the 10-mile yard sale brings in 90%.
It's the event of the year. Goddamn.
That's why
you will act the same.
No, I won't, Jamie. We'll be face to face and be able to enjoy each other so much more.
Yep. More than this?
Right now, it's so hard because. You got other people seeing you naked all the time, being able to spend time with you and do things with you for work, Jamie. But when you come back and you say you ate the golden pussy and you're in love with Maggie Jo, how do you think that makes me feel?
What about Lauren's pussy?
Lauren has a fantastic
pussy. Doesn't make me feel very good.
Exactly. You're talking all about Jamie's golden pussy.
Here I am concentrating on us.
I think it makes me feel being accused.
Here I am concentrating on us, and you're out there living your fucking life, doing things with friends and family, enjoying your life and working. And here I am sitting in my trailer alone with my dogs that I neglect, constantly on with you on my mind because I got nothing better to do, Jamie. Do you see now why I'm upset? And he can say that and literally not hear any of the other things that he just said. Do you see now? I'm not complaining. I'm just saying it doesn't make any sense.
This dog shit every other day, Lord.
I know it doesn't make you feel good. I know. And that's something that I need to work on. Because I know how it feels.
But I am never put into consideration. Selfish.
All right, so I need to take your feelings more into consideration. I'll start doing that. I got to tell you, Jamie, though, we got
to
figure out.
You don't get to sit here and try to guilt me about how you feel.
Oh, you cut him off at the knees. He was just about to go into his we've got to do better thing. You know, we've got to stop doing this and that. And you cut him off right at the robot cut him off right at the fucking knees.
Great timing.
He even gasped a little bit. Like he got caught. He's about to go into another speech. He was going into speech mode.
Yeah, he's about to talk about how special she was and how, you know.
Yeah, well, he does it. You know, in his mind, he's thinking it's the big speech from the movie where he goes in about how, you know, we do have our challenges, but we love each other and we're going to work and get through this. It's like just a different variation of that each time. Sorry, go ahead, TLR.
I'm just saying he was looking for any excuse, like any half excuse for a Hallmark moment that he can manufacture. And just like go into this monologue about what the meaning of love and everything that he loves about her.
The meaning of love and Christmas.
Yeah. And Christmas, yeah. Hell yeah. They go hand in hand.
What I'm trying to say is I love you and I fucking love Christmas. And then
it's about giving. It's the season. It's called the season of giving for a reason, Jamie. It's
not about gifts. The real gifts are the people you love.
And I love you, and you're my gift. Merry Christmas, you piece of shit.
Now show me your fucking tits, but wrap them in a bow for Christmas. Yeah. Now that would be
what I want for Christmas.
Them titties in a bow.
And the movie would be called Titties for Christmas.
No, I don't know if that would be the title.
Come on.
Gift wrap.
I'm trying to get a little edgy.
No, guys, it wouldn't be called gift wrap nips reborn. That would not be. Have you guys ever seen a Hallmark movie?
Yeah, Titties for Christmas fits in with their whole,
Bows for hoes, you know?
Yeah, bows for hoes. Yeah. Hallmark. Welcome to the Hallmark channel.
Yeah.
Tonight, Titties for Christmas. Where Lauren learns
that the real
the greatest gift of all is those titties.
Lauren looks like Tiny Tim in the movie.
Right. Yeah.
Please, Mom, may I please get the tits? That's all he wants. Give the man some tits.
Yeah.
Give the man some tits. He's seen your puss. He's seen your fucking butt. Why are you holding on the tits?
He's that trifecta.
That's it.
Everybody else gets to, for fuck's sake. Right?
Jamie Boutte.
Yeah, God, the fact that he bought that name is insane, too. He went to probation. He went to his probation officer and said, can you look up Jamie Boutte and find out if she's real? Are you fucking kidding me? You're telling me he's sober? That's nuts.
Jamie Boutte.
That is absurd.
Jamie ass would have been a little heavy-handed.
That's like one notch below that. That's crazy.
So I didn't load it up for this one, but there actually is a story out of like Detroit or Philadelphia about a Dr. Boutte. I'm not even joking. She did plastic surgery and shit like that, but she got arrested because she was making TikToks while she was doing illegal surgeries on people that she wasn't supposed to be doing in this clinic. Yeah, she was making TikToks, like pulling people's fat out and stuff, but her actual name is Dr. Boutte. So we'll have to watch that next time. That's the only Boutte they could find online.
Jamie, the thing is, she's on my insurance, honestly.
Billy, come on now.
The thing is, some of the things that I'm saying, you're not hearing.
Yeah, her hearing ears.
Like you're going on the computer. And, is all about you. Like you going on the computer and flirting with other guys.
Oh, other guy.
That's not about us. That's about you.
You don't know that I do that.
You've told me that you do.
You don't know that I do that.
Yeah, I do, because you told
me. So I have a question. What if Jamie's kink was getting other guys excited, not doing anything with them, but getting other guys excited because it made her feel empowered and sexy? And then that, in turn, made her want Lorne more. Would he be okay with it?
That'd be a fine line to walk.
You know, you get what I'm saying, right? Like, if she wanted to go be flirty, and because she enjoyed being flirty, but she wasn't cheating, but it made her want to be more sexual with Lorne, would Lorne be okay with it, or would he want all that shit cut out?
I mean, if it only resulted in sex with Lauren, then maybe he'd be okay with it. Like, if he was every part of the process, like she was texting him the whole time or whatever, like these guys are looking at me, I'm thinking about you.
I
think he'd be cool.
He would need to be part of it.
Yeah, I think he'd be cool with it at the beginning, but I think it would wear off real fast.
And I also think if it didn't result in sex each time, then he would not be okay with it.
Yeah, there'd be problems. Right.
Yeah. And like after he got used to it, he'd be like, "What? Am I not enough? Can I?
Yeah, the turns yeah, around? Yeah.
Talk to you for God's sake, yeah.
You need these fucking guys. Well, and that would be his concern, that she'd get close to it. So he'd want it to be different people. He wouldn't want any repeats. It'd have to be people that she was never going to talk to again, because he would be concerned you're going to get fucking close to him and have an emotional affair.
Hold me.
One time.
You didn't tell me one time. You didn't tell me one time.
Sure.
Okay, what about last night when you were flirting with Will?
I wasn't.
Do you remember what he said when he came in the room?
Wow, wow, wee, wow.
He said my booty that thing. I was popping it up.
His eyes popped out of his head. His tongue fell out of his mouth and hit the floor.
And he said, "Hamana, hamana, hamana, hamana."
Right, he said, "Awuga." Yeah, right. Smoke came out of his ears and hearts. Yeah, popped out of his eyes.
He was floating off the air like that goddamn cartoon wolf. He was just staring at titties, staring at titties. But Jamie was popping her booty up in the air. Is that what's going on here, Hillborn?
Yeah, sort of. Like, Will walks in and he's like, put that down, put that thing down. And then, I'm not going to spank it, Jamie. And Lauren's like,
get so it. Jamie was waving it around, wanting a quick swat.
Just a quick, little thwap, you know?
Just a friendly smack on the ass from a friend.
Two friends just smacking the shit out of each other's asses, you know?
Minus the flip flop, because with the flip flop, then it's Lauren and Jill, just Lauren and Jill.
Right, you know that just brings up bad memories. So clearly, she didn't want to do that to Lauren. She was being thoughtful without.
I want to remind you guys, if you're in jail, leave the blacks alone. leave the blacks alone. The Mexicans read alone. This message brought to you from the most worst.
Fair thing. And you prompted up more. And he said, put it down.
Three times.
I'm just pointing it out.
You said computer. When was that on the computer?
What about Chef Jeff?
What about him? This will make the fourth time for this.
Yeah, it's the fourth time because you want to spend so much time with Chef Jeff.
Explain that.
And he's giving you a cooking class. Well, how many people was in the cooking class?
Yeah, back on Chef Jeff again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like how many people were in that class of yours, huh?
Yeah, let's talk about that. He doesn't want to talk about the past, but let me just bring up this real quick. Let me bring up something from the past that I didn't like very much.
Yeah, real quick.
I'm going to bring this up.
Retain how to make those sausages better if it's a one-on-one class. Don't you want her to be good at cooking for when she gets there, Lauren?
Yeah, but why can't it be foods that are not shaped? What's wrong with spaghetti?
Oh, no dick foods. I forgot.
Well, spaghetti kind of looks like a cock, you know, a little bit.
Yeah. That long, big. Oh, that's a whole big plate of cocks.
A lot of cocks on that plate, Jamie.
How many cocks do you need, Jamie?
You're telling me it's not sexual? Come on.
Going to this.
I believe you about Chef Jeff, but some of the things that you say. You know, makes me stop and think, you know, wait a minute, she just told me that she's not flirting with him.
Okay, I see you haven't learned.
Jamie, don't.
Don't do that.
You can't put it all on me. You gotta think about the things that you're doing, too.
Anyway, it's both of us. What did Stacey and Sean say?
They won. Well, Sean, I already told you what Sean said. That was in class. Stacy wants to. I told you what Stacy said too. She wants to talk to you, but she's got. She wants to know that you know all about me, and she wants to get your information because she has to have it where you're dealing with me.
Why?
I'm not on probation. Make sure, I'm not talking to
no,
her.
No, I told her that too. She said it doesn't matter. She said she has something to do with you. I need her information so that I know that.
Thank you, Guru.
Legitimate and that she's of age and.
Guru.
Sleep. Wow.
And I'm glad that everyone's on their behavior. You didn't have to kick anyone tonight. Thank you, Guru. You're a real one.
So why bring it up? You said you agreed she wasn't entitled to that information.
Because before you... So, because you're gonna be here.
Then why did you
that part? Why did I bring it up? Because it's gonna come up. I'm quite sure it's gonna come up. I got to talk to my lawyer about it too, in case it does come up while I'm talking to him.
What the fuck is he talking about?
He's getting off probation.
Lawyer talk.
Oh, okay.
He's getting off probation. Anytime he mentions a lawyer, I think that's what he's talking about.
He's getting off probation.
He's getting off probation again.
Any day now.
It's that, or he's going to sue us or the community or YouTube to get money. It's one of those.
Wow.
Yeah, it's finally time to sue Clobbering Time.
I mean, right now is the perfect time too.
Yeah, time to strike.
He hasn't streamed in a while, his source of power has dwindled by the week.
Right, he's weak. He's at his weakest. He's
weakening.
Fascinating.
I heard his butthole's hurting.
Oh well, it's getting better.
Still healing.
It's getting better. Wow. I did quite a job. So it's gonna take a while.
Right.
It's gonna take a while.
He'll be better by Lord Namas.
Oh, perfect.
Lord Namas, yes.
Stop, guys. That's moderators. Even if it's a host, guys, don't feel afraid to call someone out because you guys have a job to do.
You were the wrench moderator. That's what the wrenches mean, right? Moderator, wrench, moderator. Wrench moderator, you showed me right there that you were the wrench moderator. But guess what?
And then Reborn, there's one more thing that you need to see. Sometimes even the most alpha man needs a helping hand.
The lone wolf searches for a pack, longing for something more.
Because in a world full of betas, we need something to separate the men from the boys.
A feral scent to tell the ladies, you don't just know the score, you invented the game.
It smells like bacon and a basketball. That's good, right?
It's not a scent made for a woman.
But it's a scent made for women. You dig?
What's it gonna be, Playboy? You can either step up
or step off. The choice is yours. Right on. I liked it. I thought that sounded really good. Yeah, what do you think of that, Reborn?
I would like to get like a sponsorship deal going with this.
Well, you're in luck because we have a live read tonight that we're gonna do.
Man,
slightly different than that commercial. I will warn you ahead of time. It's a little different.
Oh boy.
In what way?
No, T-Li, we're fine.
okay, cool.
Oh no.
As long as we're good.
No, you're not gonna be here Friday.
No, of course.
What do you mean, of course?
So she doesn't need it.
No, I was saying that she might bring it up. I didn't finish saying what I was thinking. She might bring it up Friday. So it's like I got to talk to my lawyer about that before, because he's going to call me at 10 and then we got to do a conference call at 10:30. With Sean and Stacy.
Do you think those conference calls with Sean and Stacy are like the conference calls when they were first trolling Lord and like just random lawyers just hop on? Hello? Just like, yeah. No, they're just there waiting. Hold on, I'm calling Dan. Hello? He's just, all of a sudden he's just there.
No dial tone, no.
No dial, like nothing. I love how people just randomly pop up in the call. Hello? I called her. God damn it, when he stopped calling people.
Yeah. Mike, why is your meeting with them exactly?
Because it's about me getting out of class. Dummy. And stop taking the class. And I know that your name is going to come up because they're trying to say that this is the reason that they want me in class, because I have these relationships that I haven't been in person with the person, with the woman yet, and they think that that concerns them for some reason. I don't know why.
And what if you still have taken the class?
If I still have to take it, then I still have to take it. I'm going to try to not take it. I mean, they really can't come up with a reason why I need to be in that class. Stacy said that she thinks I need to be in some counseling. And that's what I mentioned to him about Allie. I said, Bryce took me out of my counseling with Allie, and Allie didn't agree with it, and I didn't agree with it. And at the time, Allie was the only one that I trusted to talk to. Stacy said she would look into that. And then Allie's luck posted also. She's right in Skowhegan now. Huh?
Allie was sick of you.
No, Allie wasn't sick of me. Okay. See, why would you say that?
That's jealousy.
You didn't even... why did you say that? You didn't even
hear that laugh. He thinks that Jamie is jealous.
Yeah, oh yeah, he's all excited now.
It makes him so happy.
He wants it so bad.
Oh my God, you're so... Honey, you... Jamie,
she's not around anymore.
Jamie, she wanted to help me. She didn't want anything to do with me. Her only concern, Jamie, to be honest, was making me a better person for you, so you should actually like her. Right? How hard is that? How hard is that? Everyone's trying to steal Jamie's pedo boyfriend. That's got to be hard.
Everyone wants someone so in demand. And you know,
yeah. Lucky Jamie.
Go, Allie.
If I had insight into your sessions, she wanted you gone.
If you what?
Trying to talk sense into a wall is impossible.
Honey, I was talking at the same time you started asking that. All I heard was if you would be gone. If something, you would be gone.
Yeah, I'm talking about Ally. Trying to talk sense into a wall is impossible.
No, I know.
Not drywall. Tell it, Lauren.
Believe me, I know.
Believe me, I know.
Right, how did she help you exactly?
She was the only one that I trusted to talk to at the time.
I don't think that was the question.
That's the answer.
Get a lot of things out. A lot of frustrations out.
You're getting, yeah. So deal with it.
To actually talk to somebody. Well, basically like I talked to you.
Did you change your behavior while you talked to her?
I did some, yeah, because she gave me a lot of things to think about. No, I didn't stop drinking at the time. No.
What did you do then?
I slowed down my drinking.
Oh,
that's the same thing.
Because after I stopped seeing Elliot, I started drinking more again.
Like the
right.
Instead of having 18 beers, he had 12.
Okay, right. Honey, slow it down.
That's a reduction. That's a reduction. Hold on. It's Alexa's news to up.
What?
You guys aren't looking for... I'm sorry. My Alexa kept going off. But you guys are looking for a big sweep. You know, someone who needs to lose 100 pounds, they don't start off losing 100 pounds. That's its progress. So if Allie got him... from 18 beers to 12 beers, you guys are looking at it going, ha ha ha, he's drinking a 12 pack, but that means there's 6 more beers for Tony.
True, but like, Tony deserves.
Yeah.
He stopped drinking that amount of beer. He's got cancer. You know, like 3-4 years. So, I mean, by the time he's 75, he might be down to 1.
Yeah, exactly. See, that's progress. That is progress. Reborn. Now, see, Reborn gets it. I don't. Yeah, I don't. This guy's a fucking moron. It's just the way that he. I just love the way that all of his arguments can be turned around on him, and they can be pointed back. He's like Mac from Always Sunny. Just he knows exactly what the fuck is wrong with him, but he wants to find the faults in everyone else.
Yeah,
so it's just never his fault. And just like Mac, he also feels like his mom really loves him when she absolutely does not.
You vote. <And he'll,
laughs> I tacked on mass.
When I tell you things, you act like you don't believe me.
I don't.
But you give me hell for the same for doing the same thing.
You are a liar.
See?
You probably weren't making progress in therapy, and it was time for Ali to move on.
You do the same thing to me that you're doing right now. You say that I do, that I, that you say things
about not wanting to end it, but she actually wanted to.
No, she didn't.
Oh, there's that little giggle.
Because Allie was very straightforward, and she told me.
How do you know?
Because she told me.
What did she say?
She said that I would have one more week of seeing her, and then that would be it. She said that Bryce sent her a thing that...
She said, Lauren, I've got news. Someone else drew the short straw, and now I am no longer your counselor as of next week. Thank fucking God. And that was it.
She sat there on the party right there in front of him.
that was it.
He wanted her to sign me off, and I said, you're kidding me. And she said, no. I said, why would he want you to sign me off when you're the only one that I trust to talk to? Because Bryce had known, I had told my probation officer, which was Maria at the time, that Allie was the only one that I trusted to talk to. And I know Maria told Bryce. So Bryce wanted Allie to sign me off. And so that didn't make any sense. And right. Allie told me that she talked to him and told him that she didn't think it was a good idea to sign me off from seeing her yet. And he said that he wanted her to sign me off anyway.
See, and this is how Lauren gets hustled to go and buy cars. They classic good cop, bad cop. Lauren, I would love to keep being your counselor, but Bryce doesn't want me to. Lauren, I went and I fought for you. I fought my ass off, but Bryce basically told me that you are my job. And Lauren, as much as I'd love to continue being your counselor, I've got to be able to feed myself. So... yeah, Lauren, it looks like you're going to have a new counselor, and it's tearing me up. You have no idea how much this hurts me to have to do, but starting next week, you'll be seeing someone new. And it's just that easy. Because then the supervisor gets to continue being the bad guy, and you're playing good cop. I do the same shit with trolling. You always do good cop, bad cop. Good cop, bad cop is so much fun.
Pass the buck to your superior.
Yeah, right? Yeah. But when you do cards, when you sell cards, you do the same shit. You go up to the desk.
Oh, my manager, right?
Yeah, and Lauren's got bad credit, so he's already a bad credit customer. So you already know that if he can qualify for something, you're going to be able to jack him. You're going to be able to put him something he doesn't want, and you're going to power book. You're going to add shit to the invoice that the car doesn't even have, so he can add on thousands of extra dollars to the price. And you're going to explain to him that it's actually good for him that you're doing that. So you go up to the desk, and you're like, and they're talking, and you're like, yeah, this guy's a fucking moron. Whatever we can get out of
deal, baby.
And then you go back and you go, man, my fucking manager, that guy's an asshole. Anyway, this is the closest I can get. And I mean, you know, and you just, it's good cop, bad cop. They're the bad guy, you're the good guy, and you're going to get him in something. And you really want to see him leave the lot in a used car of his choosing. And you're going to make sure that he gets to do that, no matter what your fucking asshole manager says. Lauren got good cop, bad cop.
Oh, yeah, that's, he's hilarious. An easy mark.
It's hilarious.
Yeah, like we haven't gotten to any like calls or anything regarding him being swindled by the mayor of Italy, right? Like we just kind of know that it happened. Yeah, yeah,
that's yeah. Amazing. I actually don't know anything about that. Okay. So,
do you want me to hold off?
Is it in a call somewhere?
Not out. It's not out yet. But yeah, he talks about being scammed. Well, he talks about all the great investments he's in, but they're scams.
What was the mayor of Italy scam?
Something about like the mayor of Italy. I think it's president, but I misspoke and said mayor. Mayor of Italy wanted to buy. This is going to sound crazy, Wes, and you tell me. I mean, apparently Italy's trying to buy a property up in Cornville, Maine,
for camping.
Look at land and prices, and then get back to them. And
can I say something?
Yeah, yeah.
I think it'd be crazy for Italy not to buy land in Cornville, Maine. So please continue.
There you go. Yeah. So like it somehow, you know, he pays for something to help get him going, and then you know he's out of money, and the mayor of Italy never shows up.
What?
Yeah.
Hold on. Did Lauren drive to the airport to pick up the mayor of Italy just the same airport where Casey was supposed to fly into?
He's there holding a Mexican flag.
He's waving a Mexican flag with a fake mustache on.
Doesn't know what the flag looks like.
And he had a line. He had a line that he'd been working on. I weren't going to bring any pizza, but I did bring the mayor of Italy with me. He was going to say that when he walked to his mom's house.
Right.
Mayo, meet my mom.
Hey, you want some pork pie? Want some guacamole, the food of your people? Yeah. Fresh guacamole. Yeah,
I don't know what that is. My mom calls it a mango, and then him and the mayor of Italy just sitting at a table eating a fucking mango. It's some hard boiled eggs. That's a conversation starter. That's what that is. That's a great story. How much money Lauren actually sent the guy?
On that one, no. I know that a few website scams. He dropped a couple grand on. I think in total he was up to. I think I lost track at about $6,000 he had lost on scams.
Well, you call them scams, but they were investment opportunities.
Investments, yes.
You got to spend money to make money, Reborn. You got to spend money to make money.
That's right. That's right.
Any one of the and we also know that Lorne does have FOMO, which is what sent him to Bowling Green, because like there's no way he would have missed out on that. And that's why he would fall for any of this other bullshit, is because like, he doesn't want to give up on Jamie just in case Jamie actually does have titties and a vagina that will be available to him.
Yeah.
He's skeptical, but there might be a vagina at the end of that rainbow.
That's right.
And so like, yeah, he would be. I'm sure he's on a list of people. There is a list of people that you can that have been scammed. That people pass around, and I'm sure he's on that list, because once you get on there, mm-hmm. and people know you're an easy mark, holy shit! Like this, if he ever does get Social Security, he's gonna lose all of it to a Nigerian check scam.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, he was tossed around a few times. If you go check out Pat's channel, he's got a poem he wrote to one of the scammers.
Oh, okay. I've heard people say the, what is it? It's been a long time.
It's been a long time since this loan went through or some shit like that.
Yeah, see, I know that one. I know that one part.
He was getting pissed that they kept asking for more money. And so he gave him more money and then wrote the poem and was like, this is going to definitely go my way this time.
So, it's like they money, because that's what they do. They want a little bit of money, and then they want more money.
Yeah,
and then that sunk cost value, like sitting at a slot machine, and you put in $100, you're not going to get up. You want to get your money back out of it.
Yeah.
So,
oh yeah, you know, and then it's like, oh no, customs is involved now, and
we got to grease some palms. We got to grease some palms, guys. That's the way international business works.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah.
You still needed to be therapy, but just not with her, and you misunderstood.
No, she knew I needed therapy with her because she knew I trusted her. She told Bryce that.
Wasn't she for your alcohol?
She was for my alcohol, and plus for personal therapy to be able to talk to.
Don't make things up.
Why would you say that? I'm literally telling you, and you're saying I'm making it up.
She was a drug and alcohol counselor, yes.
Yes, she was the only one that was licensed to do that. That was at the facility. But that wasn't her normal thing that she was doing. The only thing that she did with me. She was also a counselor so that I would have somebody to talk to help me be able to get past some things.
To fall in love with, because that's all I was.
To understand some things better.
Well, it clearly didn't work.
Well, Jamie, I talked to you a lot about some of the things I talked to Allie about.
What does that mean?
So something works. I wasn't able to talk to anybody.
Something. I'm still having the same issues that I was having 4 years ago, so obviously something worked.
She was making real progress.
That doesn't make any sense.
Mm-mm.
It's like I've met people who told me that they have a really good mechanic, and then they go, my car's at the mechanic every week. I love my mechanic. That's the only person I trust with my car. There's a good mechanic you don't need to see every week.
No, they do a really good job.
every week I'm there, and it's never that expensive. It's like manageable that I can afford.
I wasn't able to talk to anybody before, and I've let more out with you than I have with a lot of people.
Sure you have.
I have. I try to tell you that, and you don't believe me. I can't help it if you don't believe me on it.
Right, just like when you told me you weren't engaged before.
Well, some things I forgot about or wanted to forget about.
Right.
Jamie, I never stuck with anybody like I've been sticking with you. I've never stuck with anybody like I've been sticking with you.
Sure you haven't.
Trying to tell you that I haven't. I don't know how to make you understand that I haven't.
Again, I'm friends with Will. Think you forget that?
No, I don't forget that.
Right, why would you think I forget that? Your ex.
Well, no, Winnie. I weren't with Winnie as long as what I've been with you.
Sure.
Well, I weren't.
Sure.
you know Will. You're friends with Will, remember? So you know that I weren't.
How long were you with her?
I think I was with Winnie. Oh. There are a few times that we broke up there. Maybe a total 7 months, maybe. I don't even think it was that long, really. It was off and on. I don't know. Maybe it was a little longer than that.
How many times was he engaged to Winnie?
I'm not sure. I want to say they only engaged one time, but they were engaged forever. But I could be wrong.
It just seemed like there was so much stuff that went on for them to have been together for 7 months in his head.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I'm not great with that timeline.
Because normally that's the kind of thing that people, you know, like you overestimate how long you're in a relationship. You don't weigh under.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
So that's kind of weird.
Well, he does love to overestimate with the robot. We were together for 2 years. No, they weren't.
How long were they together?
They're still together.
Yeah. We're still talking.
They got engaged twice in the course of like 7 months. And then they cut it off, and they weren't actually together from that point on, but they talked for like another year.
Another year
the way you of just talk.
Yeah. Of when we're like working towards a relationship in air quotes. Yeah,
trying to get back together.
Trying to see if we can make it work. And by that, it's Lauren getting jealous of everything she does and demanding that they get married.
I'm crying too, Jamie. We don't want to be apart. Yes. That's one of my favorite ones. You're crying too. We don't want to be apart.
Do you hear yourself?
Don't you hear yourself, Jamie?
He's so stupid.
If he was smarter, he would be decent. He would be like good at gaslighting. Because he has like the ingredients to gaslight. Yeah. He just can't put them together.
Yeah, if he were just a bit smarter, he'd be a lot more. I always say dangerous, but just
no. I agree. Well, I mean, because you see, when he had the opportunity, the first place he would go and look, he would look for people to groom online. And if he was smarter, he would have. He might have gotten caught at one point, but he would have been able to get away with it for a much longer time and more successfully.
Because
He had a pattern. He had a pattern down singing. Like he knew he had a script that he followed with Kayla.
Oh yeah, he still does this damn near the same script with everyone.
You know who else uses basically the same script? Jorin.
Well,
he's gonna be my genie.
Hey, you know anything about genies? Not broken, you
know? Let me ask you a question. What are your thoughts on high ponytails and gold shoes? Will you be my genie?
Yeah. Do you like saying master? Just wondering.
I still love when the genie's at his work and he can't stop looking at her feet, even though he wants her to leave.
God damn. He's like, shit. Can't turn this off.
Can I make her go? This is very strange. What's strange about a genie dancing at your work and singing you a song, Jorin? What's strange about that? Robot, you tell him.
Yeah. Hello, Jorin.
I am a robot genie.
Gun shy a lot because of some things that was going on that was fucked up. Mm-hmm. So it was like we were off and on a lot. So
Reborn, you have to head out.
Yeah, I gotta head out here in a
Reborn.
Minute.
Can we do this live read real quick before you go? It'll only take a minute.
Sure. Yeah.
I would hate for you to leave without
without the live read. Yeah.
Let me send.
Sorry to cut it short, guys. I gotta get sleep.
No, we're almost done anyway. But yeah, let me send this over to you.
Oh boy, I get to proofread it. You know.
Yeah. Absolutely. Right.
Not that you can change it, but you do get to see it first.
Right. Oh, cool.
All right. There you go.
All right, hold on.
Oh boy.
Yeah, there's been some
finally.
There's been some issues.
He's getting called out.
It's about time.
I may as well get into this, yeah.
Yeah, let me know when And are you ready to? Oh, sorry. You ready, Hillborn? Just read it. Totally normal. Don't even think it's a totally normal live read that we're doing for Step Up Body Spray. And I'm sure none of it will even you'll never hear anything about.
Yeah, they'll never come up again, right?
Just the one played every week for months. It's just the one and done. So I will start us off. Hey, TLI, you smell great. Is that Step Up?
No, my brother. When it comes to Step Up, I stepped off.
Word. No doubt. I guess this is because of all those lawsuits.
Right on. I just want to say, I am in no way legally or financially responsible for any birth defects caused by the use of Step Up body spray.
and neither am I. Wait a second. Who is the owner of Step Up Body Spray?
Hi, I'm Reborn Armstrong. I dropped the Armstrong, but inventor and sole owner of Step Up Body Spray. I am a rich man because I cut corners and targeted my product to an urban market.
This is an amateur hour. Start this. What are you doing?
I'll start from. I'm a rich man because I cut corners and target my product to an urban market. Also, I'm from Canada. Sorry, not sorry.
Damn, playa, what a sneaky thing to do.
Do you care about the birth defects? Don't you care about the children?
Nope. I also want to say that I and I alone should be held legally and financially responsible for any and all babies born with wings, flippers, or little flesh wheels.
I don't feel like you're taking this seriously.
This is the most
feels
serious.
Feels like you want to get blamed for the flesh wheels.
Let me. Do not blame Wes and TLI for making great commercials. It's not their fault they're so talented and handsome.
Right on.
Drink Celsius too. Give it to your baby.
That's a great commercial.
I had no idea you did that.
Yeah. You know, flesh wheels.
I did not know you were all so wealthy.
Apparently.
Congrats.
Well, he cuts corners.
I mean, who wouldn't be wealthy if you cut all those corners?
I cut corners in surf and urban market. Don't you care about the children? Nope.
Nope.
Hilborn, thank you so much for coming on. I really
and there will be justice for what you did.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I probably won't thank you after this.
No, I'm sure nothing will be made from that, dude. Don't even worry about it.
There better be flesh wheels in the video.
Flippers, wings, and flesh wheels. Reborn, thank you. When are you streaming? Is it Sundays with COD? Is that the next time we'll see you?
Yeah.
Can you give everyone a sleep well before you go?
A sleep well. Sleep well. Make sure your babies with wings and flesh wings sleep well.
Give them a Celsius.
Give them a Celsius in a bottle.
All right, Reborn, have a good one. I'll talk to you later.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
What'd you think of that? What'd you think of that live reading?
That was really powerful. I had no idea that the owner of Step Up had done all those things. Like, I knew that it smelled good, but made me feel bad.
Yeah.
Now you know why. And now I do. Like, if I was a baby, I would have been fucked. Thank God I'm not.
Nope.
Christ, I'm not a baby. I would have gotten all kinds of growths and whatnot. Flesh wheels sound terrible. I don't want to be a fucking berserk monster. I don't need that in my life right now. I'm busy.
I'll just stick to Axe body spray. That's what
I'll
went
stick
back
to Axe. If it means no flesh wheels, I'll stick to Axe. That's why I Look, stepped off.
I'm not
some... step off.
I just want everyone again to reiterate that we are not legally or financially responsible for any birth defects you'll choose,
especially not financially.
more so financially.
Yeah. I would not mind going to jail, but I will not pay a fucking dime for those deformed little shits.
Prove
what
that's my
juice children.
Prove that's my flipper baby.
Yeah. Prove I caused that flipper baby. You can't. You can get Free Willy out of my face.
Maybe it was 8 or 9 months. Maybe it was off and on a lot because of the fucked up shit that she was doing. It was fucked up. And well, at that time, I didn't even know she was Winnie when her and I started.
Oh, right. Like my fucked up shit. playing Donkey Kong and whatnot.
Mm-hmm. Okay, honey, the fucked up shit with you.
Right.
Was being so close to Will.
Right.
That was a big. That was a lot of fucked up shit.
Thought it was the computer.
That was fucked up too, because I felt second to a computer.
Right.
I did. So you.
You feel second always. Forget it.
Well, you would forget all about me because you were playing Donkey Kong. You would forget all about me because you were playing Donkey Kong.
One time.
Seriously?
Donkey Kong without getting shit.
Yeah. Well, which Donkey Kong was it, though?
It was more
than I guess it depends.
On Don.
We're talking Donkey Kong 3?
Right.
When we're talking Donkey Kong Country, I can understand. That's a good game.
Yeah.
No, I could do that. That was hard. I didn't like that game at all.
Oh, the I love hard games. Yeah, I love Tropical Freeze. That's my favorite one.
Battletoads. And Mahjong.
Games, right, fellas? We love them. Girls hate them.
Oh, you get a one if you like games.
What if you like games?
I'm not going to name them. I don't remember the dates.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, Winnie, I didn't know she was. Her name was even Winnie.
And you bitched about 30 minutes.
With Winnie, I didn't even know her name was Winnie till like 3 or 4 months later.
I don't care.
Well, you should, because you want to know this stuff, then you ask me later, and I say I told you, and you say, no, you didn't.
I'm good.
When the fact is, I tried to tell you, but you don't want to listen. See? Matter of fact, I think I've told you about it once already.
Sorry, I got hung up on something.
Huh?
Sorry, I got hung up on something.
Okay.
Yeah, on who?
Who exactly? Who is he?
I know it's not Chores or some shit.
It's a guy. Ready? What is breathing?
No, he's dying. Jamie, I love you. I love you.
Because I knew I loved you from the beginning.
Good for you.
He's dying from neglect. Jamie's not giving him anything back. He's pouring everything he can right now. Right now, he is pouring a 5-gallon bucket of love into a barrel with a hole in it. And do you know what's happening to all the love?
Falling up into the dirt.
It's just running into the dirt.
Yeah.
So now you understand why he sounds the way he does.
Yeah, now we know why he's so run down. He's been pouring his love into the dirt.
To every relationship after relationship after relationship. Yeah. And there's been no fruit from this outpouring of love, because none of it's being saved. None of it's being harvested. No one's doing anything sound with it. It's just spilling out into the dirt, much like his piss in his own yard.
Yeah, his piss on his kitchen floor.
Exactly. His piss, his bodily fluids represent the love that's being wasted on a daily basis with people like the robot and Case 3 and the other Casey and the other Casey and Winnie.
Right. Debbie. Right.
It's not his fault.
And like all those people are actually like two people, to be clear. They're like two ladies. Five of those women. Yeah, two women.
See? And that's what you have to say to that? Seriously?
The way you treated me and continue to treat me made me stop, and I don't anymore.
Oh, I found out why Hilborn had to go. Jesse's dad took his phone, told him it was time to go to bed.
He's
being too loud.
That'll happen.
Yeah. he rented the other side of that room that she was going to rent to me.
Right.
So Jesse's dad came in, took his laptop, phone, and his vibrator. And
Eelborn, give me that goddamn vibrator.
Now he's done for the night. So if you guys want to know, that's why Hillborn's gone.
He just pulled it out and handed it to him.
Just handed it right over to him in a plastic bag.
So here you go. You want it so bad. I was using the damn thing, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
What do you want me to do, Jamie? You want me to say, it's okay. Go ahead and walk around in front of whoever naked. I'm not going to say anything about it because I'm okay with it.
You don't get to say anything.
I'm not going to say that. I want him not okay with it.
When did I do that last?
It's been a long time, but if I wouldn't have said anything, would you still be doing it?
So why are you mentioning it?
Well, because you're saying the way that I treat you. You're saying the way that I treat you, Jamie.
Isn't that the
past? Yes, it is, but you want to talk about this stuff. Yes, but you're saying the way that I treated you. It was in the past.
Aren't we supposed to move on from the past?
Yes, but you still have to be up to understand why I reacted the way I did.
So move on from the past, but also don't move on from it if it's convenient for him. If it proves a point to you,
yes.
Then think about it all the time. Yeah.
Let's move on from the past, but I'm going to give you a brief example of something that happened in my history that I think you should be aware of.
So
that
my history, Jamie. So that you don't.
Yeah, I'd like you to not piss me off in the present. So let me give you some examples from the before times.
Yeah, it's not the past.
Yeah,
idiot.
It's just some shit that happened before. Why are you bringing up old shit?
Yes, I did.
Yes, I did.
And I apologize. I can't do anything about it if you don't accept my apology, because I mean it.
You didn't accuse me of shit with Chef Jeff again just tonight.
I didn't know. I want you to give me an answer.
Yeah.
After your flirting bit with Will last night, I wanted an answer about Chef Jeff.
Job.
But I've answered it weeks ago.
That was the past.
But you're not seeing how
it's a long time ago.
Yes, but you're not seeing how all this is connecting.
I don't have to.
So you don't have to, but then you just come back on me about it. You come back on me about it again, and it's like, because you're not wanting to understand what I'm saying now.
Fuck is he talking about?
I don't know anymore. He's like, he brings stuff up like answers that he wanted in from past conversations, but didn't get. He's like now remembering he didn't get them and be like, well, yeah, what about Chef Jeff? You never answered me on that shit.
You never told him about that. Once I said you were sleeping with him and you didn't outright deny it. So
and then like once the can is opened there, it's just everything he can think of that you didn't answer. It's gonna come out.
He creates his own truth in his head, and once that's become the truth, then nothing's gonna change his mind. Like he already knows the truth. So any evidence that you can show him is manufactured evidence, and any story that you can tell him is just bullshit, trying to get his mind off of what he already understands as the truth.
Right. It's all catfishing bullshit unless it confirms the narrative he already has.
then he's willing to listen.
Said I don't love you because of how you treat me. You mentioned me being naked, which hasn't happened in ages. I mentioned stuff you did last night, and you are stumbling over your words to justify it.
I'm not. I wasn't stumbling over my words to justify it. I was trying to get it straight in my head. I was trying to get it straight in my head while I was trying to say it at the same time. So, my bad.
You said something just tonight, too.
There you go. What about Chef Jeff? I tried to explain that to you, but you didn't want to hear it.
And you keep accusing me of shit, then expect me to just think it's fine. I have to constantly reassure you because you are the most insecure person I have ever met.
Jamie.
So again.
I want you to stop and think about this. When you went on the computer and you started talking to Rod and Todd,
mm-hmm.
I was like,
No, hold, shut the fuck up,
Rod and Todd. Yeah.
Shut the fuck up, Jamie, because he was going somewhere with this. How dare you? Lord, get back to what you were saying about Rod and Todd. Jamie, you're going
to
listen.
You were talking to Rod and Todd.
Yeah, he was, you know, he was going somewhere. He was about, he'd found his way because Lauren's perpetually in like a, he's in the middle of a maze and there's just a lot of different doors that all lead to Sheetrock Talk or I Love You or something like that. But there are a few of those corridors that lead to accusations against people that Lauren is jealous of. And he had found his way to one of those exits and then he gets blocked. He gets blocked by the fucking robot.
Yeah. Oh, well, I mean, and the thing is, like, the Sheetrock Talk is what he's trying to get back to. Like,
exactly.
That's what he wants. Like, he wants to be boring her to death with this.
But if he's in the middle of an argument.
That's quality time, yeah.
If he's in the middle of an argument, finding his way to one of those, that's like getting community chest in Monopoly. Like, when he gets right. If he feels like he's on the defensive and he can bring up something that he's defensive about, he feels like they cancel each other out.
And he gets to, like, get his blood moving around for the first time. And, you know,
yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
All the better.
Like, it's like exercise without having to exercise.
Yeah, it's the only time he gets to feel anymore.
Go ahead, Lauren. Tell her about Rod and Todd and why you're upset.
Yeah, please.
That's the problem right there. You don't care how I feel about it.
Boom.
No, it isn't.
Kapow.
It is.
Answer to that.
When you started talking to Rod and Todd, main thing you said was Rod was a nerd that was a virgin. Todd was a muscular guy.
How I feel for 20 months. Don't care, Lauren.
She was getting hit on by a jock and a nerd, Lauren. Is that?
Yeah, what I do care how you feel, James.
That's what we're believing.
A jock and a fucking nerd, just like every 80s movie he's ever seen.
Yeah, of course. That's
and you know the jock had on this Letterman jacket.
Whole time he never takes it off. He keeps it on during sex too.
When they make sweet love, just the Letterman jacket. Because that man earned a varsity letter in fucking, and Lauren knows it.
And he needs everyone else to know too, especially the people he's fucking.
Jamie, I do care how you feel.
No, you don't.
But I also care that you care how I feel too. Mm-hmm. This is a two-way thing. We've got to concentrate on how each other feels, and not do things that I can make the other one.
Feelings last night, Lauren.
Tell me more.
Oh, but you care about them.
I do care about your feelings.
Just give me
I was pissed off last night.
What did I say about my feelings last night, Lauren?
That I didn't care about them?
Incorrect.
Well, I'm trying to guess because I already
care about them.
Okay. Jamie, I already told you that
it's
I didn't
not just
retain
about
them.
You.
No, it's not just about me.
It is.
It is not, Jamie. And I know it isn't. It's about you, too. And I want to treat you right, too.
You haven't yet.
Lauren.
You have failed miserably on that front.
Yeah, come on, buddy.
Lauren. Did he power down?
Yeah, I think this was exhausting.
He's in sleep mode?
Yeah, he's like, what the fuck am I even supposed to say? Like, because he's... He's got nothing more to say. He's like shitting out all these feelings, more these things he needs answers to, not getting any answers. He's tired.
Yeah, I mean, it's been an hour. There's still 12 minutes to go, and at this point he knows that nothing he says is going to turn it around.
At this point, he's ready just to try again tomorrow, which he will do. This exact same thing tomorrow.
Jamie, I know how special you are. I know how special we are to each other. I'm just going to let you get some sleep, and I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Yeah, right. He'll sing one more song, leave it as a voicemail, and be done with it.
What song do you think it'll be?
Probably one of the ones he sang already, just like again, because he only knows so many songs.
He should sing Blister in the Sun.
Right, Blister in the Sun, yeah. Maybe Jethro Tull.
That'd be a nice change of pace, wouldn't it?
Yeah, just like sing her Aqualung before bed.
Aqualung!
<Da-na-na-na-na. laughs> I love you, baby.
And I didn't... As far as me getting upset about things with Rod and Todd, that's something I can't help. Because a sexual thing came out of it. And that's why I was so defensive about Chef Jeff.
I need to send you the things you want so you feel better. Yet forgets about the pictures I have sent, or the gifts I have sent. Those don't mean jack shit, because Lorne wants a new thing to look at, so all that goes out the window.
I mean, yes.
What's up, Elena? Exactly. Well,
Jimmy, it's not a matter if it's a new thing to look at. It's a matter of it's you. What are you saying fucking unreal for?
Yeah, why?
Fucking ungrateful.
I'm not ungrateful.
Yes, you are.
He's just not grateful for what he got. There's a difference.
It wasn't me wanting more pictures of you being ungrateful.
Got you there, Jamie.
Now she just looks stupid.
Yep. They can train a computer to beat a man in chess, but you can't beat this man's intellect.
Yeah, sorry.
Program terminating. Just explosion. Right.
System malfunction.
You don't have to ask for pictures of me, Jamie.
Wanted last night. What was your response? I'm fake and quote, I put you in a tight spot, didn't I, Jamie? That's how.
I need you to think about what I have to deal with.
You don't appreciate what you have. You focus on what you don't have.
Yeah, I don't have you here with me.
That's the only thing missing.
Right.
That's what I'm wanting, is you here with me. And I can't have that.
Yeah, that fourth wall in the trailer would really go a long way.
Yeah, but they could put... He literally needs a second person to help put it up. So, yeah,
right. I mean, that's the thing. Maybe that's what he means. See, like the second that she gets there, she'll be able to like help him lift the fucking fourth wall so he can have a full home.
Finally. That's it. And think about this. Yeah. Think about this. With the two of them working together, that's $1,500 an hour in labor for free.
Yeah. And imagine if she takes him, if he takes her to the teardown house, that's, you know, twice the amount of bolt, like garbage and shit that he,
well,
that
you call it garbage in that trailer. Yeah, like you tear that stuff down and you make it into insulation, walls, like chandeliers.
Yeah, just grind shit up and make it into insulation. Is that how it works?
The problem with you is you don't know how to upcycle anything. You just want to buy everything new off the rack.
Yeah, I guess that's my problem.
Yeah, like you're all about, let's go to Pier 1 Imports, Pier 1 Imports. All I ever hear from you is Pier 1 Imports and Bed Bath & Beyond, but there is...
I practically live at Pier 1. Everyone knows that about me. Oh, that TLI, he's the Pier 1 king.
I, when I couldn't get a hold of you, I knew that you were at Pier 1 arguing with them about a coupon. I just knew it.
Right. I'm like, these nautical-themed pillows were 40% off online, and now I get here and they're 30% off in store. That's nonsense.
And you just kept saying, what's the deal? What's the deal? And they know. They know. You'll get it.
Yeah.
They right now.
We aren't talking about that.
And it sucks. It
does. We aren't talking about that.
Why not? Guess what?
I really need you to understand what I have to deal with probation.
That's, see, I think what you fuck up when you try and turn the romantic conversation into your into a conversation about probation. Yeah.
There's not a romantic conversation in the world that involves U.S. probation, I think.
Well, you remember what Socrates said. Romantic conversations about probation only lead to masturbation.
Oh, it was, I didn't know Socrates was a poet.
That was Socrates. Yeah, it was Socrates. Yeah, Socrates him, yeah. Smith. Socrates Smith.
Socrates Smith.
Socrates Smith. But that's how it goes. So if you're having a romantic conversation and it leads to talk about probation, then prepare for a long night of masturbation.
Right. Socrates Smith, the R&B singer.
Then everyone snaps.
Right. From the 80s. Yeah.
Some steps need to be taken sometime that I can't do anything about it. They're going to ask me about it. They're going to pressure me about it. And there's nothing I can do about it. All they want to know is that you're real, that you're not screwing with me, that you're not catfishing me. They want to know the stuff.
I send you my dildo. I send you my panties, lol. I send you brussy juice and pictures when I feel like it, and they mean nothing to you because if you don't get what you want when you demand it, I'm fake. That's so fucking hurtful and disrespectful.
Yeah,
and stop blaming probation, Lorne. You have been doing this from the beginning. Stop looking for someone else to blame. Holy shit, be a man.
Lorne. That didn't turn out the way you were hoping.
Oops.
Hopefully you understand what I'm saying.
I love you is what I'm saying.
Because you're not here face to face with me. This is what probation's problem is.
There is no way they give a shit that she's not there.
No.
They just want to make sure she's not a child. That's literally the only thing they give a shit. And that she doesn't have a felony, that you're not talking to someone who's like gonna send you child porn or something. That's really it.
I mean, you would think if anything, what probation is saying is, Lorne, this proves that you don't need to be off probation because you're still putting yourself in situations that could potentially send you back to prison. And you do it willingly.
Yeah.
And you are so stupid. I mean, because if they just listen to 20 minutes of any given call, Lorne, you are so stupid. You will put yourself, you're putting yourself and other people in danger just by getting online.
Right. Honestly, a contender for my favorite Lorne delusion is his idea of probation as a matchmaker for him. Like he really thinks that they want him to have a girlfriend that's there in person, and that's their biggest concern.
Well, they know he deserves
it. Like they don't give a shit. They're like, just because the part of it is there, it's court ordered therapy. Like they don't care about your well-being really. It's they have somebody who will talk to you about your shit because, like, just to make sure you're not actively seeking out children. But it's not for your benefit, Lauren. It's not Match.com.
Yeah,
it's
they're trying to US make a probation. Trying to make the public safe. They could give a shit about you and your heart and making sure you're in a successful relationship.
So, it's idiotic. It's his biggest delusion. He's so stupid.
I don't know. I think his biggest delusion is the one that that country singer he would have had a chance.
That's pretty bad.
That's my favorite. God, that's so good. He really thinks he would have a chance.
Right, like we had this call with Tiffany where he's like still talking about like, what do you mean? You don't think I could sing professionally as a
company? Yeah, and he's like, and she's like,
of course not. You sound terrible. Like, oh, like, well, I guess like, you didn't like my songs then. Oh, okay.
You never heard me sing a pop song.
Yeah, sorry. That's the only thing holding you back was the genre.
I mean, I've heard him sing Three's Company, and I know that's gold.
Yeah, well, that's what I want to do. That's as good as it gets.
Well, you know what I'm going to say, but you don't want to listen. You don't want to listen to anything I'm saying. I can't do anything about it, Jamie.
You are blaming probation for how you acted the entire relationship?
No, I'm not blaming probation. Blame my reaction from past right, relationships.
So what's your excuse for them?
I'm blaming my reaction for past relationships that I shouldn't have brought in into our relationship. I was wrong to bring it into.
Not yourself.
Come on, Jamie. I'm trying to tell you I'm blaming myself.
Why give him a chance.
But you're not listening.
Jamie.
I was getting there.
This is pathetic. Good night.
Jamie.
So much for any response to your last question, I guess. Off. I don't know why you asked it if you weren't going to listen to my response, but hang up instead.
Hello?
I'll make you a deal. How about this?
What?
Jamie?
Oh, this is gonna be a little monologue from Jamie.
He's probably already taking his dick out, thinking it's gonna be good.
I can almost hear him typing furiously on the other end.
There. I'll send you one titty tonight, and the other one's on like a titty layaway plan.
All right, and then the other one I'll show you in person.
I agree after
I'll
some of this.
To Stacy, but I'll mention every time you have sent me a nude photo and how you hound me for mine. Like tonight wanting my tits. How's that sound?
Why, is she trying to get me in trouble?
No, I mean, if it's not a problem, then they should have no issue with it.
Oh, you aren't supposed to sound? Do that.
How does that sound?
How does that sound, Jamie?
Oh, you aren't supposed to do that.
Do you know how that sounds to me?
So you should be thanking me for not sending them, right?
Well, he's got a point there.
Jamie, I told you I didn't have a problem with you not sending them. I respected that.
Thank me for not sending them.
Oh, I'll do it, Lauren. Come on, Lauren, do it.
What are you doing? I want to know why you're saying shit like this first.
Ooh, she's showing off for someone.
Thank me for not sending them.
I bet Jamie's typing with one hand and touching a dick with her other hand right now.
Oh, almost certainly. It's what she does.
Yeah,
it's her job.
And that's why she's so emboldened right now. She's showing off for some guy, some literal cocksucker.
Yeah. She's empowered.
She's got her hand on her dick. How is she not? Yeah.
That's powerful.
I want to know why you're saying shit like this first, Jamie. It's messed up. Well, stop being so annoyed.
There you go.
Okay.
That was easy. Oh.
Oh, boo.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey.
Are you done being annoyed?
Lorne, I am stressed out beyond belief.
Oh, now he's going to be cutesy after being a bitch for an hour and a half?
The other day along with your accusations.
It's fine.
On top of my business falling apart, I am in debt up to my eyebrows. My health hasn't improved much at all. And to top it all off, I'm late. Okay. So excuse me for not wanting to deal with the drama that is your probation and lawyer and the bullshit you said last night.
I mean, listen. Just relax for a couple of days, okay? Don't. We won't even talk about it for a couple of days.
Wow, he's really cooled off on this.
Did he not hear her say that she was late?
Yeah, I think he must have missed that one.
Or did he think she was like, you know, late to supper or something?
No, it continues in the next call. Like, he thought she meant late for work, like she was late for a stream, and then it's clarified that she was late for her. I didn't know you meant late for your period.
Yo, see, this is another way, you know, Lauren ain't never been in a relationship.
Nice cliffhanger.
The girl tells you that she's late, yo, the first thing I'm thinking is,
right,
She's pregnant.
You don't want that late text. How that pregnant I think you I'm is. Late text. Yeah.
Yo, how pregnant you is, it's TLIs, isn't it? I know it.
That motherfucker.
I know it's stressful. And I know that's why you're annoyed. And I understand. I really understand because I'm dealing with it too. I mean, I've been dealing with it for years.
So,
but I've learned to kind of relax after being stressed out about it.
You can tell how relaxed he is.
Yeah, he seems very laid back.
I'm stressed out because I'm late. I can't handle it.
I hope. Oh my God! What if Will was using Step Up body spray while Amy was pregnant?
Oh wow! I mean, that's going to be an issue. That's Jamie, I'm sorry. I hate to break this to you, but
hope for the wings because you do not want the flesh, Will. Flesh, Will.
Honestly, you don't really want the flippers either. The wings is probably the best case scenario. You could like kind of pass off as an X-Men, but the flesh wheels, you're just gonna you're gonna look like a monster.
You don't want the flesh wheels. So I just hope that Will was not doused in it like someone said earlier.
Right. He carries himself like someone who's doused in Step Up.
He was a Step Up man for absolute sure. You got to move. Step up now.
Don't stress out, okay? Go to work and
step up.
Call me when you're done work if you want to, okay?
Keep your mind right away from it tonight, honey. I love you and good luck with making money.
The preceding announcement.
I mean, if anyone needs to step up their game, it's Lauren Armstrong.
Yeah, he really his game was very his game was low. His game levels have never been lower than they have been here.
So we've got one last thing to watch, it's only 2 minutes. But before we do that, do you want to see Lauren dance again with the Black Kids?
Yes, I would, please.
What did you say you wanted to see Lauren do?
I would like to see him dance around to that little Uzi Bird song because I like with it. Who? And also, he looks great. With the urban youth. What do you want me? What do you want me? What are you trying to get out of me here?
Dance for us, clown. Dance for us, you monkey bitch.
Christ. Yeah, right. that's not going to get any easier to hear, Bex. That's it.
And you're not going to believe it. Lauren wasn't actually there.
He looks like he was.
Yeah, no, he's not allowed at a high school.
Right.
That would actually happen. That would be against the law if he was doing that. So, but no, that's all CGI. It's the CGI and AI is what you're looking at there. Yeah, absolute movie magic. So, Thank you. So, TLI, when are we doing another one of these?
Oh, I don't know. Whenever. Could be next.
You week. Got the yeah. moves.
Stop. You got the moves.
Yeah, we should do one next week.
Yeah. Yeah.
We should do one next week. Step up your game. We should do one next week and we'll put up a poll and let them choose what we listen to next time.
I mean, that's, again, a dangerous.
And then you had something that. Well, no. Well, actually, I'm glad you said that, because you had something that you wanted to submit. You said for Black History Month, and it's called Sweet Sugar from 1972.
Oh, finally. I'm glad.
So, yeah. Yeah, we are getting to it. I'm sorry that it took us so long, but we had Hillborn on, took a little bit longer, but let's watch the preview to 1972 Sweet Sugar, something that you said was even better than Black Mama, White Mama. So let's see.
Yeah, you know what? I'm going to go all in on this. Yes, I love this film. There's nothing wrong with it. And I endorse everything that's about to happen here. All in, baby.
All right. Oh, wait. Hold on. What the fuck? We're going back to the call. All right, here we go.
Meet Sugar. She's beautiful.
Oh.
In chains.
What?
And she's busting out, shackled to the steamy cane fields of a tropical inferno. They're women. They're warm. They're wildcats.
Hey, black gal! You gonna get Mojo some of your stuff?
I don't mess around with bush bunnies.
Now, what is this, TL?
Yeah, this is one of my... It's one of those movies. It's like a slow burn. You know what I mean?
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Now I know that White Mama was nominated for an Emmy. It did get an Oscar, an Emmy nomination for for what is it? Betty Davis. Betty was mm-hmm. it Betty Davis? Now, did anyone get nominated for an award in Sweet Sugar?
Not that I'm aware, but that's this is what you call a cult classic.
Okay. Well, let's just keep watching.
Yeah.
Hung up. The searing sting of the whip burned a brand of hate into her heart.
Jesus. Just everyone's ready for this.
Oh my god. Oh my god. TLI, what do you want?
Jesus Christ.
Well, you're
going to go this hard.
Inferno.
Oh, no. Oh!
She can cut any man down to size.
Listen to me! We can take this place! Let's go!
Warm hands, cold trigger, blazing death. An epidemic of machine gun madness. 38 caliber kittens spitting death as they claw their way to freedom. Nothing can hold her. Not chains, not bars or men. Sweet Sugar.
Actually, that looked pretty good.
I've been waiting for a long time for my shot at the belt, and this time, Pandora, it's you. March 9th, I want that belt. Yeah.
What?
You really think that you could be? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, this is the worst wrestling promo ever. We got to watch this real quick. Hold on. Because it's really good.
Didn't do it.
My shot at the belt, and this time, Pandora, it's you. March 9th, I want that belt. Yeah.
Such dedication to the character.
You really yeah.
Beat me? I can do anything. You're not even that tough. You're just all
I'm
gonna
kick your ass so much. Who the fuck is this guy? The fuck was he supposed to say?
Yeah, neither of them want the belt that bad.
He walked up like he had a line, but he never said anything.
Oh. Whoa. What is going on?
They're passionate about the sport, is what's happening.
Yeah, yeah. Whoa, wow.
Is this porn? Am I allowed to show this on YouTube?
Oh, okay, what? Now, okay, now what are you watching?
This is a guy watching a wrestling promo.
Great.
Isn't that the guy that dances for? Isn't that the guy who like stomps?
They're right there. They're 2 feet away.
Isn't that the dude that stomps for Jesus in that Reborn video that he's always showing?
No, that's not him. He's got the same like build and like the shirt and everything, but it's that's not him. That's it. That would be hilarious.
It's the same dude. I'm sure of it.
No way.
There's no way.
put his shirt on. Oh, he brought it. He did bring a shirt with him, even though he didn't know what was going on.
This video pretty much has no point. But
okay, that was the worst wrestling promo of all time.
Wow. Well, I'm glad we've just decided to end the show by watching softcore porn.
Well, I mean, it wasn't. It could have been
a good way to round it off, you know.
Hey Wes, so I'm just hanging out. I'm sick in bed and all that jazz. So yeah. And hoodle at a shot of soup. And hoodle. And hoodle. And hoodle at a shot of soup. Chit chat chitty chitty bang bang. Chit chat chitty bang bang. And hoodle at a shot of soup. Chit chat, chitty chitty bang bang, chit chat, chitty bang bang. Monkey see, monkey do, monkey see, monkey do, chit chat, chitty bang bang. I'm sick.
Yeah.
Aww. Isn't that adorable?
Poor Pickles.
poor Pickles couldn't go to work that day because she was sick. So she sent me a video to let me know that she wouldn't be going to work. It's called respect.
And that's the best way to let someone know that go on that whole fucking, you know, musical journey.
Chit chat bitty bang bang. Yeah, TLI. It was a pleasure as always. Thank you for joining me. And
Of course.
And and everyone, I will see you. I'll be back on Sunday. I'm streaming with Honest. I don't know if it's gonna be before Sunday we'll call it or after, but we'll let you guys know. I will be streaming on Super Bowl Sunday with Honest, and maybe tomorrow night I might do some KC catch up stuff. And then of course Mo Negroes on Monday 6 p.m. PST with Sloth Cat, and then hopefully Cornville Three Way. Calling from Jamaica, ma.
Right. I'm glad you're finally getting on that.
What part of Jamaica are you from, Cornville Three Way? Right by the beach. So that's how I know he knows what he's talking about. So anything else that you have to say, or can I close this out with I Can Love You Like That by All For One?
No, I think you can close it out with I Love You Like That.
I think so too. All right, so thank you so much, everyone. Perry, can you nicely say goodbye to everyone?
Fuck all of you, you motherfuckers! Good day, you fucking assholes!
Thought it would be.
Rescue you. You like romantic movies, and you never will forget the way you felt when Romeo kissed Juliet.
And all this time that you've been waiting, you don't have to wait no more. I can love you like that.
I don't even think this was a song Lauren was singing anymore, was it?
No, I don't think so. What song was it?
I can't remember. Similar. I know it was All For One song, but I just can't remember what it was now because I got a Super Bowl, get it? Weed, right?
Right.
Tonight.
Yeah, drugs.
And I forgot to do this.
Sleep. Wow.
I'm Eva Little McNuggets, and I wrote this song all by myself from scratch. From scratch. From scratch. From scratch.
I'm a
mess right now, kid.
Is this all for me and you, or are you going to put me some more stupid bullshit that I don't want to hear?
Tells me we got to have a fun time.
It's not even my birthday. Oh my god.
I'm not Mr. Peanut. I've been on. I can't get in trouble for it.
I've always loved kids.
Just not in that way. A bad person.
Son of a bitch. Am I contagious?
I'm ready for more boys.
Are you crying?
Yeah. I'm not Mr. Peanut.
I'm not fat.
How can you say that?
My pussy smells like 100% beef burger.
You're not anyone's boy because you literally do not realize you're the predator.
You go, girl. Oh my god.
I don't want to hear fucking rap shit. I don't like it.
My dicks were very unflattering, unlike yours.
Wait, hold on, what?
I'm evil little McNuggets, and I love it.